Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. Great dear friends and lovers of freedom, this is Radio Biafra House of Service, coming to you through Radio Biafra London. Today we are live and direct. Today is the 15th day of November in the year of our Lord 2020. We have once again come in order to enlighten, in order to make sure that people hear the truth without mincing words, because here we are apolitical. Do you know what is the meaning of apolitical? We don't polish lies and try to turn it into truth. No. We neither also don't or do not try to be politically correct with the truth. We say it's wrong. You know what is wrong? Many people that understand what is chemistry or acid, you have concentrated acid, very dangerous, very effective. That is what we dish out here, the truth without mincing words. It doesn't matter who it pains. It doesn't matter who is the victim of our proclamation of the truth. The issue is the substance of what you are saying is what matters. What matters is the truth. Because Nigerian mainstream media have hidden the truth from the people right from time immemorial. That is why people are now turned into beasts. That is why people are ruling on ignorance. Ignorance abounds in Nigeria. That is why there is fallen hegemony. That is why there is no accountability. The politicians are going on with impunity, no repercussions for their evil. Do you know what happened? As somebody rightly said, that it is not, I think it's Albert Einstein. He said it's not the evil people that will destroy the world. But do you know what? It is those that sees evil. The good people that sees evil and will not speak. They fail to speak. These are the people that will destroy the world. Therefore, when the evil doers are on the rampage and good people keep quiet, do not count yourself as innocent. You are part of what is going on. You are part of the wickedness and evil. Nigeria is a quagmire today because good people even fail to speak up. They fail to not only speak up, to act up. But here on Radio Biafra, we are here to expose the truth without mincing words. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter the repercussion, because we have sworn an oath in order to speak the truth and continue speaking the truth, even if it takes our lives. We must change the status quo. We want everybody to be free. It is not only for Biafrans, no. It is for all the ethnic nationalities that are being caged in that quagmire called Nigeria to be free. Everybody should be free, because our mantra is man is born free. Everybody should be given the same equal opportunities, and there you will see the sky will be everybody's limit. And that is the American dream. That is why you see America today on top of every other country, because they believe in freedom. Therefore, once again, we are here live and direct in order to say it as it is. Before I continue to introduce my comrades and guests we have today, I must first of all go on in order to do as we used to do by presenting this hallowed platform in the hands of Chukwuka Abiyama, the God of our ancestors. Our Father who art in heaven, the creator of the whole universe, hallowed be thy name. We have once again. Behold, we are here to dish out the truth, to speak the truth as it is, to make sure that people are enlightened. Because the problem of the black man is in the brain. That is why we are bent on trying to surgically remove idiocy and foolishness by making sure that truth is exposed. Because the Holy Book says that you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free. Therefore, we have once again gathered in order to do as we used to do, in order to do it as we have sworn an oath to do. Behold those that are bent on killing us because we are saying the truth, because we are on the path of the truth. Kill them, destroy them, and give us more power in order to continue exposing and destroying them, because they are children of evil and wickedness. They are there tormenting the people. They are there benefiting from the miseries of ordinary people. But here we say enough is enough. Therefore, Chukwu Okeabiam, even our leader I present before thee, Maazi Nnamdi Okwuchukwu Kanu, who has made it possible for us to have voice in this hallowed platform, for people to be enlightened. Keep him, O God, and give him more power in order to make sure that Nigeria is being destroyed. And through the ashes of the destroyed Nigeria will rise up many nations that are being caged in that dungeon, in that British zoo called Nigeria. Thank you, Chukwu Okeabiam, for answering our prayers. In your name we pray. He said, I once again welcome each and every one of you hearing my voice through the four corners of this planet Earth, because we are simulcasting through FM stations in many parts of, most part of Biafra land, I should say, in Lagos, in Abuja, in Kano, and counting. You can also hear our voice by uploading IPOB Community Radio. It is a low data consuming app. Download it through the Google app in your mobile phone, and you'll be hearing our voice. Also, we are on satellite. Therefore, I once again welcome each and every one of you. Please come here with a dose of your common sense, because after all, common sense is not common. You cannot get common sense by going to formal education. No, that is why you see many people in Nigeria with their PhDs, with their masters, with everything they have as education, they don't have common sense. And that is why ordinary cattle rearers are ruling over everybody, because of lack of common sense. But here we are trying to make sure that you come back with your common sense. Your common sense will be restored. Today is the 15th day of November 2020, and today is Sunday. I say once again, welcome, welcome, and welcome. Therefore, let me go direct to bringing in my comrade, who will in turn continue speaking, because we have a guest in our midst today, from also Nasarawa State, which is going to also speak. Therefore, let me start by bringing in Maazi Jacob. Please, can you unmute your microphone and talk to us? Are you there, Maazi? Maazi Jacob, can you hear me?
Yes, Maazi, I do.
Once more, I want to appreciate Maazi Jonathan, our founder, the Kanu. Actually, it's a privilege and a better opportunity for we, Egon people, to identify with Biafra. I spoke around 3 p.m. today. I really explained the situation and the condition that we Egon people found ourselves. Actually, the situation we are is no longer favorable, is too pathetic on us. I think we actually want to identify ourselves with the IPOB Community Radio, because I discovered that there is emancipation and liberation that is ongoing, so we cannot be left aside. We must have to join the forces. Actually, the Egon people of Nasarawa State, as I said earlier today, we are about 1.5 million. But unfortunately, the machineries of the Islam community, the Fulani and the Hausa people, relegated us out of the system of the entire state. As I am speaking to the as I'm speaking now, right from the creation of the state in 1996, God people have been marginalized out of the They are strangers now, they push aside. We have not never been to governance. We have never had the mantle of leadership of the state, the governance of the state. We have not been there, and they have empowered themselves. They have a cabal that they begin to empower. They don't want even a God people not to talk of a Christian to become a leader in the state. So we are being relocated to a background that we, our voice is too, we are being limited. In fact, when my brother told me about IPOP community radio, and I said, glory be to God, this is a time for the emancipation and the liberation of a God people. We are in Middle Belt. In fact, the Middle Belt entirely, not only a God people. You could imagine what is happening in Plateau State. You can imagine what is happening in Benue. You can imagine what is happening in Kogi. You can imagine what is happening in Niger State. You can imagine what is happening in Abuja FTT. Now, we, the people, because we refuse to be a North Central. You know, when Abacha, Babangida and Abacha came up with the zone, they created Middle Belt as North Central. And I remember when the late Solomon Lar was PDP chairman, he went to Arewa House in Guna. They asked him to introduce himself, and he said his name is the Honorable Excellency Solomon Lar. He said from Middle Belt. That singular statement caused him a lot of havoc. They removed him from the PDP national chairman. They say, how can he say he's a Middle Belter? Why not say no something?
Go on.
The Hausa people, they have been because our people, they don't have this education. They deceive us. They are always trying. They are together with us. They use Islamic to deceive most of my people in Nasarawa State. As I am talking to you, I have about 50 or 40%. They are Muslims, and they use religion to deceive them. They don't know the truth. In fact, our cultures is in about in East Asia. Our cultures is in trouble. They begin to, in fact, most of the cultural name we have like our king is called Aregon, but they are now saying Serki. Serki. Serki is not in our culture. Serki is Hausa name. We don't have Serki in our land. We have Aren. We have a lot of things that they introduced. They exoticated our culture by bringing Fulani and Hausa culture. And this thing have really affected us. And I am telling you, this thing caused us a lot of setback. Now, what am I saying here? We have been denied the mantle of leadership in all the three arms of government. In judiciary, we have been denied. In legislative, we have been denied. In executive, we have been denied. Now, how can we cope up? The situation is more than our capacity. I think IPOBO Community Radio is an avenue for us to express our grievances. We are dying in silence, and I thank God that God bring a thinkable machine like Kanu, who came up with the idea of this radio for the whole world to know the kind of the suffering that we are undergoing. So I think the situation that is happening now, we thank God that the liberation is approaching. We identify ourselves with the IPOB. We are saying what they are doing is the right thing, and that is why we are joining them, the forces. We are saying this is not about if the country can be divided into 5 or 6 pieces. I think I have agreed with that. We should have Southern, we should have Biafra, we should have Middle Belt as a country. So my imagination is too much. Why should a region, a Hausa and Fulani region, dominating the entire country? They have invented the machinery. Look at what happened in Nasarawa State between 2012 and 2011, 2013. As our governor, because of the second tenure, he went and invented machinery from Mali, from Chad, from Niger. The Fulani, they came. They fought us more than 1 year. They destroy our properties. They destroy our land. They destroy our houses because the machinery we are brought to kill Igbo people. But we thank God because our God really fought for us. And that was when Ombase came up. And when Ombase came up, we do self-defense. And we are able to defend our people. It was because Ombase defeated the machinery that some of us today we are talking. Amen. But they are using another way to deal with us, to marginalize us. They are using the instrument of the government to shut us mouth, to shut our mouth. Because all our people, they are farmers. We don't have industry. We don't have any company. So we are depending on our farm product. Imagine last year, 3 months ago, I went home. People could not go to their farm again because Fulani are in the bush. Because the Fulani, they are in the bush. When you go, our women go, they rape our women. They kill people in their farm. They will allow cattle to enter your farm. They will eat up your crop and you have no mouth to talk. We say, no, this is enough. We need to wake up. And I think according to, you know, as a man of God, in the book of Isaiah 60 verse 1, he said, arise and shine. And when we discover that Kanu and other prominent Igbo who have tinkable machines, they rose up and they are shining. And I say, no. When my brother told me yesterday, I said, this is the platform that I must belong. And that's why I told him, I said, we will join them with all forces because our voice must be heard. And our voice must be heard. We are pleading to entire world to please to come for our aid. Entirely, Nasarawa State, we have prominent sons and prominent personality that they can rule the state. But they were being denied. People like Labara Maku, people like Solomon Ehuga, people like Dr. Just. But they have been denied. It's getting out of hand. And as I am talking to you, even now, we still have Fulani in the state. They move around with cutlass. They move around with gun. When you talk much in the bush, they will just kill you and they will go. Nobody will talk. So when my brother introduced me to this platform yesterday, I was so happy. And I said, no, the liberation of Igbo people is ready. It has come. And that is why I am speaking with all my strength to tell the whole world, to tell the whole world that look at this situation we are passing through. Our women have become a widow overnight because the Fulani will come a community, they will kill all people in the community. Many communities in Igbo land have been destroyed. Look at what they have been suffering. If an entire community, Nubel, some one Fulani man said, their mission is to capture Nubel. By God's grace, they will not capture the bell. Because God is what we say. But if you give another chance, I will still speak up. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Go on. Yeah. Hello? That's for. What go, man? Hello?
Mebongo. Yes.
What go, man?
I'm hearing you.
I thank you very much. I know the reason why I give you small time to speak this English. So let everybody understand what we are passing through. This platform is Igon platform. So tell us, we'll bring it here and we advise us, we'll be together. So that even because those are politicians, because they deceive them, as you said it. And about to Mulong Goma, Mulong Bu, Kazakaza, don't make your support. And that's how they do it. Even if you're going to go in Boland, I can see you. They go to Boland. They will go meet a new governor. Say you will be vice president. They will leave him. They will go meet that all. You will be vice president. They will go meet IBM. No, they cut their head jam. Now if you want to say you will be vice president. They can go. How can they just do the poke official within themselves? Before you know it now, they don't blow in. They don't just find their way inside. So this time around, the time has come. Omba Bogu, Omba Lawi here. So, since we have gotten a media, we are going to air our voice every day. They are in trouble. So, maybe we're going to send a program here. So, just stay into the program. Make you know, go on. Say, I want to sign off. So, let me go back to studio. Before then, I guess most more headline news. One that may read that here. Post headline, what's happening in Nigeria? What's happening in Nigeria today? So, and so that in Mudao, you go there on Mudao, at the end of the day, people are going to be calling. Any other question? If people have a question for you, you answer the question. So, before I continue, I have more headline here. which I want to go, and small headline. So, look, a country who they will travel, if you go country, you will say this is a country. Every government have every citizen attack. But Nigeria here, nothing. If you listen to our Today Women program today, so you're going to say we are far, far behind. And this country, there's nobody on earth can rule this country will have a peace. Nobody on this on the earth with this present situation. Because the day Mandela, Macron is restructuring, but they don't want restructuring. They don't want division. They want to leave it as it is because they are the major beneficiary. And it is not good. I don't know why a stranger will come to my house and tell me how to live and teach me how to live. No, it's wrong. So this thing, we must have to correct it. So I have today, I have my headline here. What we'll do before I hand over, without going to the studio. Today, this Malan Galadima, Suleiman Atunwana Galadima, Buba Galadima, he said that Buhari, you will leave this country in pieces after 2023. What he said, this is a capture. He said that Buhari will leave this country in pieces after 2023. Now, what is he saying? The country already is already in pieces. Why must he wait? Why must he wait till that time? So the country is already in pieces. So, and then another you say, they said one of these N-Stars protests, when they shoot for Lekki tollgate, the guy said, after 3 weeks, I'm still having bullet in my body. After 3 weeks, he still get bullet in body. But those army said, they don't shoot. So, that's country you see. How can you lack ammunition on protests and protesters? So, that's the other one. And another one here, they said that the government today, they invest Zera Polytechnic and kidnap 3 staff. Gunmen invite Zera Polytechnic and that their staff contact worker and kidnap 3 men because the country does no security. Gunmen shoot me anyhow. Because the Fulani, they are minority in the country. They are minority. And I suppose why a Fulani people are less than 3 million in a country, and you are expecting to rule a 200 million people. It's not possible. It's not possible. So they make it by force, by fire, you have to leave, whether good or bad, which is not good. That's why I raise up for Biafra. Today, Biafra are fighting to go to their own country and build their own paradise. Oduduwa, they are fighting to go down, go down to find a paradise. Now, we have to fight our own. So we like to have our own. We don't have our own country. What do you call our own country? And the way for me, there, with the middle bed, as well from Nasarawa State now, because Nasarawa State, we are the majority. That is why they don't want us to explode. They don't want us to know. They don't want to silence us because if you silence the majority, then they can do this minority. They cannot talk. But as long as we come today, we the majority has to come out today, that we have come out today to say no. And bet me, in a very few times, in a very short while, Things is going to change. So, and on the of effect, the man just said, Governor, be very careful. Nigeria youth are hungry and angry. Said Nigeria youth are hungry and angry. Say, in they drop Nigeria, and then they drop Governor Gombe here because since when Gombe go so see, you know, they here because he don't see sign. So, Nigerian youth are planning very fast. They plan something bad against this government that they have to be very careful. Like saying this is so, I said, B. And today, in the last news here today, they say one gunman shoot one man today. In that, I said, the man killed the man died. No, gun rapid everywhere. So, the code is not safe. So, majority of we, will not go forward in the world. This country will happen. So, now here I will stop today. Let me go back to studio, hand over to Maoga. So, when we come back, we continue. During the call, people started calling and we answer any question you have for us. So, and that's for you, just hold into that line. The end of the program. Thank you very much, Mazi. Get there from there.
Thank you very much. This is Radio Biafra House of Service coming to you through the auspices of Radio Biafra London. We must continue. My name remains Mazi Jonathan Chinedu from Olo Province of Biafra Land. And I thank our guest today. Because, there is something like as it is written in the Bible, the parable of the marriage, when person holding the marriage, the invitees, he invited people, but each one gave excuse during the day of the marriage feast. He cooked and each and every one of them gave excuses. Yeah, I couldn't come because this and that. I have an appointment. Now the man told his servant, sent them on the road. He said, go and bring anybody. Anybody you see on the street, just bring him in. Let them come. That is what is happening, because we are here. This platform belongs to everybody. As far as you aspire for freedom, that is what is happening. You need to identify yourself. In Nasarawa State, we have other ethnicities. We have other people. In the whole of the Middle Belt, you have other people. The Gwandara, all these other people, the Numana, Nungu, all these people, it is high time for you also to come and take your space. That is it. Because everybody should need freedom. If you are ignorant of freedom, I'm telling you, know ye that you are a slave. That is it. So, it's not only meant for a gun or Biafra or Igbo or this and that. Any to whom it may concern, it's an open invitation. Because this is the voice of freedom. We want people's eyes to be open, and that is what we have been doing. Because the basic problem we are having is ignorance. Problems of Nigerians are in the head. And that is why we have gone to the taproot, to the grassroots, in order to surgically remove that problem. It doesn't matter whether you are an Akon or you are outside even. It doesn't matter whether you are from Babu or Bukalunga tribe or Bale or Bambuko or Banda or Beto. It doesn't also matter whether you are from Dansa or Diba or Gengle or Gono, Gonia. All these tribes, let me tell you one thing. The people gaining in Nigeria are only the politicians, which they are foreign masters. That is the British. They are the creator of Nigeria with the whole politicians. They are the people gaining. It is high time for people to take up their position. Let me tell you, people don't understand the power they have. Do you see the very little minute test in this NSAS protest? Do you see the power the people possess? Police, we are running. Military, we are on the run. Everybody on the run. If the people should rise up with unison, it doesn't matter who you, which tribe you are, these politicians will be just to oblivion. They are nothing, because they are very few. So I once again welcome each and every one of you. It doesn't matter your tribe. It is time for you to rise up, because this British creation, Nigeria, is a British creation. It's an insult to even the indigenous people. It's an insult. Let me tell you one thing, because some people might be saying this and that. Let me tell you, do you know that many European countries, let me say it, many European countries are less than 1 million in population. Do you know that? No, I don't know whether you understand. You know, the Russia in population has a population of 145 million plus. 145.9 million. That is the biggest, the highest, most populous country in Europe. Followed by Germany and UK, France, all this, in all this way. But let me shock you, many European countries are not up to 1 million. Do you know that? Do you know a country called Montenegro? Montenegro has a population of 628,000. 628,000 only. Not up to 1 million in population. They are not up to the population of a country. And they are a country progressing. Many Africans are in Montenegro seeking asylum. Many are there working. They are living good. Indigenous people. Do you understand? Montenegro has a population of 628,000 only. Do you know about Luxembourg? Luxembourg has a population of 625,000. Malta. People used to call here from Malta. It has a population of 441,000 only. Iceland that went to World Cup that played even in the Nigerian group. Do you know their population? Their population is 341,000. It's a full-fledged country with the people living far more better than all the African countries combined. But they are not up to 1 million. They are not even up to 500,000. Iceland. You go there, you see many Africans, you see Nigerians there. But when they come to Africa, when they talk about a God, they say, oh, it's very small to be a country. Who tell you that? It's an insult. Channel Islands is 173,000 only. Channel Island is a country of its own, an independent country. Isle of Man is 85,000. Andorra, do you know that Andorra is a country in Europe? Do you know that? It's 77,000 only. What of Faroe Islands? How you know all these things is, if Europe is playing qualification, their football qualification, all these countries play as independent countries. Faroe Islands is 48,000 only. Do you know what about Monaco? You are hearing about Monaco. They have, is it only one club? And they play even in French, France, because it's a country, an independent country. They have only 39,000 population. 39,000. What of Liechtenstein? Liechtenstein has a population of 38,000. What of San Marino? San Marino has a population of 33,000. Almost 34,000 only. What of Gibraltar? Gibraltar, you are seeing between, is it Morocco and Spain? Gibraltar. It has a population of 33,000. But it's a country. You understand that? So, all this, you know, the problem we Africans have is ignorance. The Europeans came. They joined, they erased any, dissolve every kingdom, country, nations in our land. Calling these people. It's Nigeria. And you are defending it. That is why we are here, in order to make sure that people rise up. To understand that the basic problem we are having is Nigeria. It's Nigeria. A foreigner should not come and force you to be what he wants you to be. That is what I said here. I preached about day before yesterday. It makes you lower animals, you know, a pet, a dog. Because it is only a dog that you can come, bring him in, and, you know, he becomes give him any name you want. And he start wagging his tail. You understand? Call him any name you want. And he will be answering it. But if you're a real human being, if somebody calls you another name, you say, no, this is not my name. This is not my name. This is not who I am. They want to, what is happening in Nigeria, why you are seeing monsters and beasts in Nigeria is the way the Europeans, the British wants Nigeria to be. They are making an experiment. It's an experimental zoo whereby they want you to jettison who you are. As an ego man now, you say, no, I'm not a ego. No. You feel ashamed of even speaking your language. Now, because you want to be a Nigerian. Do you see that? Do you see that rubbish? It's an insult to our humanhood. It's an insult. Wanting to be, maintaining what the Europeans want you to be is an insult, I'm telling you. Why jettisoning who you are to be a Nigerian? You know, what we say here, you better think about it. You better think about it. Now, let me go straight because, you know, here we are unorthodox. You know what it means? We do things the way we want. We are original. So now, I am going to go to the topic of my submission today. But before I do that, let me make this my continuous remarks. There is nothing like Hausa Fulani as a people or as a tribe. No, it is a deceit. It is part of the Fulanization plan. That is why they coined this word, Hausa Fulani. Only in Nigeria they have this word. There is no relationship between Hausa Fulani until of recent. The Hausas are very populous. I mean, their population is very big. One of the most populous tribes in that part of the world is the Hausas. Whereas the Fulanis are minority. You know what is minority? They are not up to 7 million. Troubling the lives of everybody. These people. But do you know what they cleverly did? The Fulani, they cleverly use religion to tell Hausas, oh, we are one people, we are one people. And the Hausas accepted them. And before you know, Othman Danfodio, you know, turned the heads of the Hausas against themselves because that is the way the Fulani fight. Their modus operandi in warfare. They first of all manipulate your brain. They turn you against each other and you start fighting because they know that they cannot come conventionally, because they are very little, in population. Othman Danfodio started it. So the history of the Fulani presence in Hausa land started only in 1804, when Othman Danfodio, who they refer to as a teacher, an Islamic teacher, he was just preaching. He was a host, a visitor, born to a Fulani family that we are living in Hausa land. That time, the Hausa land were part of Songhai Empire. Do you understand that? And the Hausas were a very, very hardworking set of people. Because that time, the Hausas, they had a vibrant civilization. They were able to manufacture things. Because you know people that are advanced. You recognize people's advancements on what they are able to accomplish. That is why archaeologists today, when you see fallen or old kingdoms that doesn't exist again, they remember them by when archaeologists excavate all these old things they were able to do, like potteries, like woodwork, like stonework, different things. They say, oh, this thing has a mark of Babylon. Because the people were productive. That is how they know people, how people civilize as of that time. Productivity. What they are able to accomplish as people. Not importation, no. So, these Fulani, they manipulated the head. Othman Danfodio started teaching the Hausa that we are Muslims because Hausa accepted Islam as early as 11th century. But their type of Islam is very peaceful because they never know what is jihadism. They accepted Islam via threading. Because the Hausas were manufacturing textiles as of that time, coloring it with different bright colors, and they were exporting textiles 300, 400, 500, 600 years back to the Arabs. Didn't you see the beauty of their civilization that time? The Hausas, the people you see today as Almajiris, their ancestors were very hardworking people. But do you know why they are today turned into street beggars? Do you know why? Because of the Fulani touch. Fulani came into their midst and manipulated them using their version of Islamic religion, turning Hausa man against Hausa man, and they fought themselves, killed their king, thinking that they will continue. Do you know what the Fulani told them? The Othman Danfodio told them. He told them, oh, your kings are corrupt. Oh, why should they allow other non-Muslims to live peacefully among themselves? Oh, no. You either you're a Muslim or you are not. Even if you see your brother that is not a Muslim, you better kill him. That is, if Fulani brought jihadism in Nigerian Islam today, even in West Africa, jihadism. It was not, there was nothing like jihadism. This is their version, Wahhabi. They call it the Wahhabi version of Islam. It's the Salafis, Salafism. These are the people, the Boko Haram, the ISIS. It is being brought originally in West Africa by the Fulanis. And now, these people that we are outside, that we are practicing normal Islam, living in peace with their brothers and other ethnicities around them, the Fulani turned them against each other. And they fought. They fought each other. And who came out as the victor? The Fulani took over and killed, slaughtered all of them. Now turned the remaining ones into vassals and slaves. That is the result you have when you allow yourself to be used by a foreigner. The same way the Europeans came and used blacks, used the West African frontier force, made up of mostly Ghanaians, in order to do what? In order to capture, to fight black African brothers. They also use Senegalese riflemen to fight and capture and conquer other African brothers. The French used them, like Madagascar in 1889. That is what the Fulanis, they understand. That now they can manipulate these houses, and they manipulated them, turned them into their slaves. After, do you know what? They retained only the language. Now the Fulani use Hausa, because they know that they are populous, in order to start conquering other ethnicities in that part of the world, in the north. Coming down to Middle Belt. That is why today, when you see my brothers, my colleagues, they are talking, they mention Hausa, yes. But the people that are behind all these things are the Fulani. The Hausas are naive. They are ignorant. Because do you know why? Because the Fulani is still running their lives till death. They have turned them into their slaves, vassals, everything you can think of. Beggars till death. Because whenever the house has born their children, they take the malam, their malams take their children, take the house of the kids, right from 2 years old, saying that they are teaching them the Quran. Do you understand that? Turn them into street beggars and brainwashing them, start brainwashing them as young, that look, you people, Fulani, we Fulani are your masters, we are superior to you. That is what they tell the Hausas. The only thing they left of the Hausas is their language only. That is what remains. Do you know why? Because they know that if they didn't leave the Hausa language, that the Hausas will easily revolt, because they will understand. But they turned the Hausa, all Hausa people into slaves, but leave their language. Say, okay, let us all be speaking the language. And that is where the Hausas ignorantly accepted that we are Hausa Fulani. That is when this word came out. Hausa Fulani, we are together. If you are together, why should they turn everywhere your leadership, remove your shehus and bring their emirs? You see our brother that they were talking, even in the Middle Belt. Now they change their kings. Aroy gone. Now they change it, start calling it Sarkin. do you understand how they roll? That is why, when you are calling them Hausa Fulani, it is a very big mistake. These are Hausas and Fulanis, they are different set of people. We are also even trying to raise the awareness, sensitize the Hausas, for them to understand that this Fulani that they are calling their brothers, after all, they are not their brothers, they are their killers. But the Hausas are in a bigger mess than we can imagine, because the Fulani runs their lives. Right from when they are babies, they take them to the malam. The malam controls them. Their parents don't know about their children again, because their Fulani malams control them, train them with that brainwashed idea of Fulani superiority in them, sending them outside to go and beg. They are in a very big mess than people can imagine. And The Fulani is using this word, Hausa Fulani, in order to deceive, in order to continue rallying the Hausas around, telling them that we are one. If you are one, Hausa should ask them, if you are one, why should you impose your emir? Originally, Hausas never had emirs. They have shells. Why should you have emirs imposed on Hausa land? Why should the political representatives be mostly Fulanis in Hausa lands? Why? The Hausas are indigenous population, whereas the Fulanis are not. They are recent aliens. The Hausas were hard working set of people. The Hausas were, they are very populous. I mean, their population is big. But the Fulanis are minority. These people that are troubling our lives every day. We must continue doing the right thing. We, the Southerners and Middle Belters, let us stop calling them House of Fulani. There is nothing like House of Fulani. Separate them for who they are. They are Hausas and the Fulanis. Do you understand that? Because when you are doing this, when you are calling them House of Fulani, the Fulani is, they are laughing. They are happy. It is part of the Fulanization agenda. So do the right thing, please. Let me go straight to the, I will be so brief. The topic of my submission today, it says, the making of political dominant species. Listen attentively. The making of political dominant species. First of all, let me define what is a dominant species. It's a species in a community that exerts the greatest effects. Another one says a species that dominates in an ecological community. Another one says is a species that is more powerful, influential, or noticeable than others in a community. In the case of Nigeria, the Fulani, though they are minority in number, they are less than 7 million, they are the political dominant species. Do you understand? That is why everybody, Biafran, Oduduwa, Middle Belters, Akon, everybody is shouting against one set of people, Fulani. But we never take decisive action. Why? That is the question you should be asking yourself. Why? We have a Fulani that is less than 7 million, troubling the lives of 193 million plus. Now you ask yourself, what is it? What is it? And the Fulani, they are telling you face to face that you can't do nothing. Look at the testimony of our brothers that are speaking from Middle Belt. They are destroying everywhere. They take people's land. Even in their land, they impose everything on them. Do you know there is a reason? I want you to understand. I want to talk about the making of the political dominant species. That is it. You know, Ahmadu Bello said that Nigeria isn't a country. Rather, it's a figment of the British imagination. Because the people can never unite. You understand? Ahmad Bello understand Nigeria, yes. Or he understand the British creation. He said it pomp and plain. And I love that. I love him for that. Because he is pomp and plain. He is apolitical in his approach. But many other people that time like Azikiwe, where they rubbish everything because they want to be, they think they can be, rulers in an empire they don't create. And that is why things fell apart for us. Instead of asking, or working on Ahmad Bello's assertion that, look, we need to find out the problem. Do you know that is the reason why Britain handed over Nigeria to Ahmad Bello, to the Fulani, to control? Because they rightly understand the problem. Ahmad Bello analyzed the situation of Nigeria and said, no, we cannot be part of this. Because Nigeria is, it cannot never be one. Never. He said, he challenged the British, he said, you people say, this is the figment of your imagination. Nigeria, we are not one. How can we say, we people, we have different opposing cultures, traditions, religions. And you want us to create us as one. No, it cannot happen. And Britain, do you know why? What? Britain subtly, they understand that these people, their eyes open, they know our game. So it's better we handle, you know, in a place, for example, in a midst of people or in a house, whereby you know that one person or two people are thieves. They are thieves. If you leave the thing for other people, this other two, one person will go and steal everything and cause confusion. No person will know. So, you know, if you are going out, and what do? You hand over your thing to that thief and say, please, look at everything. I hand over this house to you, you understand? And he will not thief again. Because everything is on his responsibility. That is what the British did. Because they know that Ahmadu Bello understands the reality of Nigeria they are trying to create. Others like Azikiwe and Co, they are there, you know, fantasizing. Oh, how I will be the President General of Nigeria. Oh, how I be. The British say these are useless slaves. Leave them. This man is a kind man that understands what we are doing. Please. Let us leave these are fools. We can manipulate them a bit. That is why when they were handing over the Nigerian flag, they didn't even invite neither Azikiwe nor Awolo because they are warming up to be rulers of a country created by Britain to make it better. How can Britain say, I create a place and now you want to be more, you know, enthusiastic than us? They go and meet the Ahmad Bello that understand their game. Say, oh boy, we know, shut up, we know, you know. But you know what? We hand this country over to you. That is exactly what happened. Because the British, they understand that Ahmad Bello understood their game. They didn't do that, Ahmad Bello would pull out from the union, say, no, I cannot. They understand that. That is why they calm him down. The same way when you are going outside, among the five people in your house, you know there is one thief, one person that is a bad boy. That if you leave the thing for another people, the other four people, he will destroy, he will steal. You know what? You will call that person outside saying, you see, you are my buddy. No, I'm going out. I will come back tomorrow. So this house, you know, you see that money. It's there in the drawer. I have a 1 million naira there, okay? The whole house is your handover. Take care of it. You know, when I come back, don't worry. Everything is will be intact. I will square you. You understand what I mean? That is what the British did in Nigeria. People don't understand this. Ahmad Bello understand British game. He said it. He said Nigeria is not one and will never be one. It's like mixing water with oil. It's immixable. The Britain, they know that, oh, these people, their eyes open in what we are doing. This man understands our game. So we better meet him, corner him and meet him outside. Say, okay, we are handing over this, our creation, to you. We will be behind you, okay? Just anything we want, you job by job. Now, so leave all these fools. Let them continue jumping up one Nigeria. How they will govern? How we shall be this and that. Leave them. You understand it? And Ahmad Bello, so if that's the case, no problem. Me, I dey here now, no problem. That is the case. I'm ready. That is why you people don't understand. This is why the Fulani, they are ruining everybody's lives today in Nigeria. Because they understood the British game. Instead of Britain to allow them to spoil it, now they hand them over everything and say, keep it. Because when you give a thief your thing to keep, it's secure. That is why Nigeria is secure for Britain. If you talk, everybody there, no, we are going to know Nigeria. Once Fulani, they are waiting for Fulani to talk. Fulani said, no, the unity of Nigeria is not negotiable. And Britain can stamp it back up. It's like that. Because people, Azikiwe and Co and others, they were warming up to take over what they didn't suffer for, what they didn't create, what is inorganic. And they were educated. That is why I say common sense. It doesn't come from formal education. Do you understand that? Common sense doesn't come from formal education. You can be, you can be an illiterate, but you have common sense. You understand that? You can be an illiterate, education-wise. You don't know how to read and write, but you have common sense. I'm telling you. You can have PhD, but you don't have common sense. That is what is... Nigeria is full of intellectuals without common sense. That is why people are suffering. Because they cannot define the problem, the cause of the problem, the root cause of the problem. And that is what we are telling you here, so that your eyes will be open. Why they handed over Nigeria to Ahmad Bello? Because he understood the game of the British. How can these people, creators, telling us to go and meet, be with these unbelievers, this and that, telling, commanding us, say instead, we are not going to agree. Immediately, Britain is going, we'll go. We'll go and continue how we are living. Britain understand that. They understood it immediately. They saw it. Now, in order to calm them down, they have to give Nigeria, hand Nigeria over to them. Whereas Azikiwe and the world, they are warming up. How to become president and prime minister, this and that, to rule, to make Nigeria a great place, a great country. Britain that created them, created Nigeria. You know why he created Nigeria? For their benefits. If Nigeria becomes a great country, it will not profit Britain again, your creator. That is why he put Fulani to run everybody down. And that is why they are political dominant species in Nigeria. Do you now understand? I hope you understand. Oh, you people that are one Nigeria. Do you see the weakness of people? See Nweke. Because he wants to be a vice president to Tambuwal. They told him, you have to show that you are Nigerian, okay? This is how slaves behave. Show that you are Nigerian. People are thinking that you are supporting IPOB. What do I do? You know what to do. You know what to do. Go and do it. Immediately he came back. He declared IPOB is a terrorist group. They keep military. It's not about that. They know this started right from the time of Azikiwe. That is it. They are naive and ignorant, but they think that they go to school. You are going to school doesn't remove your naivety or ignorance. No. Only when you have common sense. Ahmad Bello, that you people think that their people doesn't go to school, they are headsmen, they this and that, but they understood the game because they are dominant species. Britain remarked them and say, if we don't hand over these people, Nigeria, to these people, they will bring us a problem. They will scatter our creation. Now hand them over power and they will continue handling everybody. That is it. And that is what is happening. But now we are trying to change the narrative. Because when you understand and know the truth shall set you free. There are many factors. Some factors that lead to their dominance. I want to tell you some of the factors that led to the Fulani dominant, political dominance. Okay, one of the factors, one, is unity. Apostle Yusuf, when he was talking, he talked about the importance of unity. The Fulani, they understand the importance of unity. That is why one of the main reasons why they are dominant species, political dominant species in Nigeria today. Unity. They refuse to be divided even by the European imposed borders in Africa. Do you think it's easy? As Europe separated and divided Africa through the Berlin Conference of 1884-85, naming different countries, Libya, Nigeria, this and that, Togo, Cameroon, this and that. Do you know that it is only Fulani that defied that borders? You know, people don't understand what this, how smart and civilized politically these Fulani are. They defied the odds of borders, European imposed borders. They refused to be divided. People don't understand the deep meaning, how this thing is deep. That is why they maintain political dominance, because they defied this separation. You know, there are Fulanis everywhere, right from Mauritania to Cameroon to Sudan. But Fulani, they tell you that they don't care about the borders of Nigeria, of Cameroon, of this and that. That is rubbish. That their nationality is Fulani. That a Fulani person that comes into Nigeria becomes automatically a Nigerian. He doesn't need to go to no protocol. Automatically. If a Fulani man goes to Cameroon, he becomes a Cameroonian. That is the way they are. Do you see the importance of unity? We are as ordinary states. In a country, ordinary states. Before, River State, I had one caller before in, I think, Ike Peters, saying that before the war, that the Igbo Cha was in the diocese of Owerri. Which is truth. I mean, the diocese, Catholic diocese, is Igbo Cha, we call Port Harcourt. Port Harcourt is in the diocese of Owerri diocese before the war. But only that they created a state called River State, Rivers. Now you see people say no. Igbo people say no, we are not Igbos. Do you see the primitivity? Do you see why we are inferior, politically inferior in Nigeria? Because our people, they act like a slave. Imagine, for example, a gun, I don't know whether there are a gun in other states, in what do you call it? Like Plateau or Niger State. Imagine, because they put artificial border between brothers. Maybe a gun in Plateau State. We say, no, we are no more a gun. We are Plateau people. This one say, no, we are Nasarawa. What is all this? Is rubbish. You deny who you are because of artificially imposed border. The Fulani defy that. Would you clap for them now? Admire them. It's not easy. If it is easy, go and do it. If it's easy, do it. Let's see. You think it's easy for a Fulani person, Nigerian Fulani, to tell you that if he sees his counterpart in Mauritania, no matter that they hardly understand themselves in their even Fufude language, because some will be mixed with French, others with English, it doesn't matter. They say they are one people, they are Fulani, they don't care. This is one of the qualities why they are dominant species. If you don't understand it today. You yourself, ordinary states in the same country. It makes you feel that, no, I'm no more Igbo. I'm Delta. You see people calling themselves the Italians, Delta. Niger Delta. Oh, Delta. Oh, Rivers. I am Bayelsa. What are these primitive Neanderthals? I'm telling you, sometimes it makes me cry. Primitive. You divide yourself. How can you stand? You continue being slaves to the dominant species. That is the truth. It's the pure truth. We don't massage words here. Because this is Radio Biafra. This is where we speak it as it is wrong. So that you check yourself. You call Fulani, they don't know anything. They are cars, this and that. Do you know why they are ruling over you? They are dominating you. Because they understand the importance of unity. There is something the apostle speak before, Apostle Yusuf, that spoke. You know what he said? He said that one of them went to a PDP meeting to be elected as they put him as a chairman or something, or party chairman in the north. Now they brought him, they introduced him, Mr. Soso, yeah, stand up. I've forgotten his name. He called. He said, okay, where are you? He said, I'm so personal. Where are you from? I'm from Middle Belt. Immediately they demoted him. They said, why will you bring this Middle Belt, this and that in our midst? You have to say that you are from North Central. For them to maintain dominance, they have to impose unity, whether you like it or not. Because they understand it is not about you, but about your own personal issue, but about the people, about the movement. That is how it is. That is the secret they have against you. And that is why they are ruling you. And you'll be complaining. Hey, these people, hey, they are ruling us. You can't do what they are doing now. You cannot do. You look at ordinary River State. Yesterday, Ebema is in River State. Ebema is in Imo. Ebema is in, is it Delta? All these things, they coin different useless names. You are River, you are Delta, you are Niger Delta, you are Stream, you are Wood. You are, tomorrow, if they, I'm telling you before God and man, if they create another useless state and call it Wood State, you will see people who say, no, I'm no more Ibo, I'm Wood. I'm Wood man, I'm Wood. You know, you see that, you look, I know I call our people, we are primitive. But here in IPOB, we are curing that primitivity. That is why we are here. We don't massage the truth. Because we cannot continue to, we know everything. We are talented. We are doing this. But what is happening? We are everywhere around the world. Are we having fun? Do we scatter around the world for holiday? We are looking for greener pasture. Why? Because the people that we are better, we should be better. They are ruining our lives, pursuing us, making policies for us to run away. And you are praising yourself. Oh, we, but we know some. You don't know nothing. You are political ignoramus. That is who you are. You don't know nothing. Whether you are PhD, I don't see you as anything. You are nothing. Because what the Fulanis are doing, you cannot do it. The unity they put on themselves, you can never do it. You understand? You can never. When you see even a pony governor is trying to, Ebony is not even part of the, if it is not for IPOB, he will just maple like that. And you are telling me that these are human beings that are supposed to progress politically? That is why they come, they scatter you, they kill you, they do everything for you, to you. And you continue crying because you're inferior, politically inferior to the Fulani. I must be honest with you. Zeke first expected it because had it been Zeke is somebody that sees the future. Had it been, he is not ignorant. You know what? That statement of Ahmad Bello, he would have analyzed it very well and tried to discuss with Ahmad Bello and support him and say, what you are saying is right, though. It's better we start negotiating, we discuss either we are going to be how we are going to be. But because of his selfishness, I'm coming to that because I'm talking about the unity. So if you see a Fulani man, clap for him politically. That is why they are ruling you. Because they understand the game of the British. Changing the land. That is why they revealed to them about the oil. That is why when we went to, when our leader, our late leader, Odumegwu Ojukwu went to Aburi Accord. He went to Aburi for Aburi Accord. They resolve everything, restructuring everything. But Britain still told them, no. Do you know what you'll be missing? Oil. Nigeria being handed on to you, Sadwana. Oh, Fulani Caliphate. Hey, we handed Nigeria over to you. Don't agree. You'll be in charge of that oil. Don't agree, otherwise you miss oil. You'll become like Niger Republic. Desolate and poor. And they come back and say, no. No, we cannot do it. No, and they come to war because of the original mistakes of our people, predecessors, politically. They made the heavy, they committed blunders. We should be outbursting it. We should be talking this. The will never come. If you are annoyed about it, you call and prove otherwise. I'm telling you honestly. Because the mess they created is what we are correcting. It cost us lives, millions of lives. And you think that we should just leave it like that out of sentiment? It's impossible. It's highly impossible. We continue mentioning it. Ahmad Bolo understood the game. You know, it's just like he understood. He's a thief. He caught the British. They are thieves. He said, "Oh boy, me, I understand what on at the duo. This thing you people are saying is Nigeria. It's just your imagination. That is what you. It's not real. We know though, because we cannot mix up with these people. We don't know. They don't know our culture. We don't know their culture. Their religion is different now. And you come now, just as a white master, tell us, oh yeah, be one country, be Nigeria. Which kind of Nigeria? How can I leave my Fulani? Become a Nigeria. Britain, they were perturbed. They went to Ahmad Bello secretly and say, oh boy, please, no expose us. We know that your eyes are open. Leave all those other Neanderthals. We can manage them. We hand them over to you so that you take care of them. If you kill them, no problem. We are at your back. Take over Nigeria. And they give Ahmad Bello said, if that's the case, no problem. Now you come. I can manage these people. That is why they're on rampage. He said, as far as Nigeria is concerned, the oil in Bayelsa belongs to Jigawa. Do you think that they're saying it for saying's sake? People don't understand what happened. So, what the Fulanis did, you cannot do it as a people. I'm telling you. Unity, they understand the power of unity. They refuse to be divided even by the European imposed borders in Africa. Do you see how powerful it is? Imagine Yoruba people in Togo and in Benin Republic. Imagine now, say they don't care, they move around anyhow they want to Nigeria or to Togo. Do you know that it is your own Yoruba brothers at the border will tell them, hey, Nibolo, where are you going? Hey, you Benin Republic, you are, he said, I'm a Yoruba, he said, come on, you are Benin, you are Togolese. The same thing in Togo, if a Nigerian, hey, you Anglophone. You see why the Fulani are ruling over us. Whereas they themselves, they don't consider all these things, all these borders, it doesn't perturb them. They see themselves as one people. They come inside Nigeria, go to anywhere without passport, without identification. Only their language, Fulani, as far as they identify themselves as Fulani, it's finished. That is how it is. It's only people that are doing it. That is why they have monopoly of power. Unity. The second one is having a long time political foresight. They always focus on the political goal of their ancestors, no matter how ridiculous it might look to others. You know, that is a Fulani for you. They don't lose focus. Do you know that consistency pays? You know, when our leader started this broadcast, many people were calling him different names, a joker. Oh, this man is this one. But he persevered. He continued. Today, IPOB is a monster around the world. Had it been that time he started looking around, this thing, I don't buy it. We wouldn't have reached where we are today. But because of perseverance, because he had a goal, he focused. That is it. That is how the Fulani, they became dominant species or political dominant species, because they are always moving forward, looking at the goal, even right from their ancestors, their great-grandfather, because each generation will warn themselves and say, look, do not forget what our great-grandfathers said. Ottoman and Fodio say, remember this country, Ahmad Bello, sorry. Ahmad Bello reiterated when they gave him the reign of power. He said, remember that this country, Nigeria, will be the estate of our great-grandfathers. That we shall never lose focus. That we shall use the middle belt and others as willing tools to achieve our purpose. and we shall never allow the South to rule over us. And one other thing, neither shall we allow the Southerners to control their destiny. What is happening today? Do we control our destiny? That is your focus. It doesn't, you know, at that time when they're talking, maybe some people will just wave it aside as with a wave of hand and say, these people, they don't know anything. They don't know anything. They continue walking towards it. They continue walking towards it. Politically, anyhow, intimidation, killing, anyhow they can. Even they themselves, they are being killed, they don't care. They continue walking towards it. And today they are receiving the dividends. The result is there. They are ruling over everybody. They are ruining the lives of everybody. To their own. That is what, you know, it's practical. In the middle bed, they are shouting. They are displacing them. They are sacking villages. Even coming to Southeast, where you call Southeast, South in general. That is why they have the audacity to be committing atrocities in our farmlands. And have you seen any Fulani governor in here come and castigate them? I mean, Fulani headsmen. It doesn't happen. No way. Instead, they defend them. Because they understand, because they know that all of them are fighting to one goal, towards one goal, dominance. And they continue being political dominant species in our lives. And all we know is to cry, to complain, to talk. Yeah. After they bring money, give, and everything is gone. Because these people, you are cheap. You are cheap. Britain knows this. They knew this right from time. They knew that Fulani are ekwekwe. You know what is ekwekwe? You don't buy them. We can't buy them with money to deviate from their mission. Britain understand them. That is why they don't want to have this confrontation with them. Instead, they give them Nigeria and say, take it. Take it. Only we'll be doing anything we want, but we support you to subjugate these people, because these are people very cheap. Their own case is different. You know, they look at us, all that non-Fulani, and they look at our case as very different. You know, these are very cheap people. Just call them and give them money, anything, or power. They forget themselves. Even they deny their identities. So, they don't take us serious. How can they? How can they? Until IPOB came. And they are surprised that these are people that you cannot buy, because we are unbribable, unbuyable. We never lose focus. You know, that is what we are doing. We are opening the eyes of people to understand the reality. I don't add sentiment on it. We say it as it is. I am talking about the making of political dominant species. Okay. Number three. I'm talking about the factors, some of the factors leading to their dominance, the Fulani political dominance in our land today. Number three, the third factor is selflessness when it comes to their communal survival. They don't, their life, their private life doesn't matter. They can put their lives just for their communal survival. That is selflessness. And the opposite is selfishness from our side, the non-Fulani, the Igbo, the Dudua, in some areas. You know? These people, mostly the Biafrans, you can look at their political leaders, their political elites. Just call them today. Anything that happened, call them. They'll be castigating. The following night, call them on phone, fill the accounts. Bring your accounts. They bring you. Fill the accounts with money. In 24 hours, they change tune. Have anybody heard about the $22.7 billion that was borrowed? No, nothing for Southeast. And they cried like little cats.
We can impeach this president if we want, but this country is not one.
These are senators, Southeast senators. When you look at them, you are looking at very primitive Neanderthals. I look at them, I don't regard them. Because in the night, when they call them and give them, leave this thing, you are in that 22.7 billion, 500 million will be for all of you people. in the political head. Leave all these things. Now, tomorrow you see them, they say, okay, we understand them. Look, you listen to their public statements. No, you know, we have to take it easy, you know, no matter. We have to have our turn. Every region, we have their turn one day because they have been bought. Britain knows that these people, they are very cheap. Very, very cheap. People you can buy cheaply. That is why when our leader started broadcasting, you know, Obasanjo looked at him and said, look, we call him miscreant. I said, look, that bed, no mind him. Ah, we shall call him. We know they just need small money. This himself, not plenty of money, at least. Even if you give him $1 million, he will go stand at the line like others. He looking at Nnamdi Kanu with the eye of Owazike and others in the creek. But little did he know that he's mistaken, because there are people and there are people. So what am I saying? One of the factors is selflessness when it comes to their communal survival. The way Fulani, they stand in solidarity politically. That is, even they, you know, they make sure that not even life of one person, one of them, their personal life doesn't matter. They defend their interests. That is why they are defending Fulani headsmen. With their life, it doesn't matter. Will you look at what is happening? In the ordinary, we that are not, IPOB that is not a, that doesn't kill. Do you see the people that even first of all proscribed it are the southeastern governors? Because they think, oh, now these people, they want to put Gari on our, sand on our Gari. Selfishness is what matters to them. We can deny his identity because he wants to be vice president. Only. So they tell him, okay, give us an example of what you can do. Just prove yourself as a Nigerian. Now, he started killing his own people. Opibu, Igbo people. You know, Opibu. Indigenous people also. Killing them. To prove that he is a good Nigerian, a strong Nigerian. How do you think that people like this can survive politically? How do you think? Whereby all of them are selfish. With only his selfish interest and benefit, he can sell everybody. His own people, he's ready to clear everybody. And you are telling me that you are asking, why are these Fulani, they are dominant? Why do they dominate everywhere? People that near Chinama, cattle headers, they rule us. Yes! Because you don't have the quality they have. Let truth be spoken. If you have the quality they have, you will do wonders. Stop calling yourself, we know something, we are talented. Yes, you're talented, but you misuse your talent. Because politically, you're zero. Let me go on. Number four, the ability to fight back in all fronts. To maintain their political dominance, they have the ability to fight back in all fronts. Anyway, political, through the media. Do you remember when Fulani headsmen is the first time, even they named them internationally the fourth most deadly terrorist organization, Fulani headsmen, is there. But did they budge? The politicians, they cause Fulani politicians every year, Rufai, do they budge out? They started defending, continue defending, even internationally. Even to the extent this guy, Rufai, threatened the international observers that if you come making sure that you will go on body parts. Can any Southerner say that? I said they don't care. They have the ability to fight back in every front. They come, they say, no, this is foreigners. So after they say, okay, these are Fulani, but you know, not all Fulani are every tribe have a criminal, so we are dealing with criminals. After they brought out this term, bandits, in order to deviate your mind from the Fulani headsmen, from their Fulani terrorists that have been raided, because they used to do meeting among them. They used to fight back. Oh boy, let us not, you know, they make it as a point of duty. Let nobody back down. Let us continue. This is hard, but we must persevere. Yeah, that is why they are politically dominant in your life. That is why they can come into your Obopo, your garden, from Mali. They come full and they come into your garden, and start grazing, scattering the whole things you suffered for. I read the other day, in Oguta, they scatter the whole farm. No, community farm, you know, hundreds of hectares of farmland, in order to cause artificial scarcity. That is how they behave. And the people, they were begging, we beg them to go now. Please go. They call police, say, we are busy in another thing, we cannot come. Governor is nowhere, his phone is off, you know. The community boys, they are begging, please, now, may I go now? Because they are dominant species. Do you understand that? If you want to be a dominant species, remove all this selfishness, lack of unity, all these things I'm reading. Remove it. Try to remove it. It's not easy. Do you see? Look at Owazike. Do you know what Owazike said? That he is urging other state governors to do what Wike have done, killing their people in the name of IPOB. That is what an Igbo man is advising. He's happy that his people are being killed. But Fulani, they can never be that. No matter how they disagree internally, they will always have a political, common political front outside. Can you do that? That's why you're suffering. That's why we're everywhere. Although we want to turn our being everywhere, IPOB have turned it into a blessing. Otherwise, you are not everywhere having fun. We are fighting peace everywhere around the world. We are seeing hell, Pepe. I tell you, everywhere around the world. You didn't go there on holiday. We are there to make because our place is a hellfire for us. So we run away. It's a truth. It must be spoken. If you don't like it, go and hug a transformer. That is it. Because we want to cure ourselves of these diseases. The making of political dominant species. Number five, let me be fast before just a few minutes. Able to play good politics for the benefit of their tribe or community. It doesn't matter even if it's politics of intimidation and absorption. Do you understand that? Being able to play good politics for the benefit of the community or the tribe, not for your own personal benefit. You know, like in what is happening now, the trend now, the Fulani, you know, what they are doing. They go meet the week, you will be vice president. You know, you are our man. Prove to us that you are our man, that you are a good Nigerian. Prove to us, otherwise we will not. I say, okay, don't worry, I know what to do. I will use this NSAS and kill my people. They say, okay, if we see, it's seen, it's believing. He went back and started killing his people. And they cause confusion between him, hatred between him and his people. That is number one. Because they are rounding them up, isolating them, so that they can be able to manipulate them. That is how the Fulani do. That is their politics. They cause confusion between you and your people. Do you understand that? But you can never cause confusion between a Fulani and their people. No, that one is no goeri. No. Now, who is superior? Is them. They are politically superior. Because they are playing good politics. The same thing they told Wike. They go and tell Okowa. Oh, Okowa, you know, you are our man. You will be vice president. So, okay? You will be vice president. So, hide it, because you are our man. So that anything they tell him, he do. Bring land for Ruga. Oh, he give to them. I say, no problem. Any person that talks, he will send the military to go and kill the person. His people. A good Nigerian. But it's not good for his people. Now, what do you profit? You are at loggerhead with your people, whereas, okay, oh yeah, good, in order to, for you to be a good Nigerian. That is what Ahmad Bello saw and said, no, I cannot practice this Nigeria. If Nigeria is for me to be at loggerhead with my people, it cannot happen. Because these people, we cannot mix with them. We are unmixable. Britain, they corner him and say, we understand. Oh, God, we know. Keep quiet. This thing, don't worry. Not you. Please. No open other people's eyes. Leave it like that. Carry Nigeria. Maintain it for us. We'll be at the back supporting you. He said, okay. If like that, now it's okay. Now be say, Nigeria is sweet now. What are the Fulani say? That Nigeria, everybody, Nigeria, to thy kingdom, till thy kingdom come, Nigeria will get. And they say that Nigeria not their own. Because they are dominant. They understood the game at any time. They played politics of intimidation and absorption. Do you know intimidation? They intimidated, like the person, according to our brother that spoke earlier, from Middle Bed. They don't want him to mention that Middle Bed. No, 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 you are from North. Is this like this how you are going to lead us in PDP? Come on, get down. They demoted him. Because they have to intimidate him in order for to be on the line. So that another person tomorrow will not say, never say Middle Bed. He said, we are all North. Solomon Lalong is the chairman of Northern Governors Forum. He's from Plateau State. His politics of intimidation. Anthony Sani from is he from Southern Kaduna? He was the chairman of Ariwa Constitutive Forum. What about Paul Olongo? They put these are good politics. They are play politics of inclusion where necessary, politics of intimidation where necessary, and absorption. They absorb you. They say what you don't want to be. They say you are you. That is who you are. You are from North. You must accept it. If you don't accept, we accept for you. You are from North. Say yes. He say yes, I'm from North, but he's from Nasarawa. How can Nasarawa be North? How can Benue be North? How can Kogi be North? Ilorin, how can Kwara be North? But they impose everybody, intimidate, and they absorb them. And say, you are not by fire, by force. Come on, say yes. He say, okay, sir, okay. We are not Tanas, okay. And that is it. Can you do that? Can you do that? You yourself, they took our people, Igbo people, put in Benue State, and they are not. And Ohanaeze Ndigbo is saying, no, leave them now. How can you force people? As David Omai was saying, can you force people to belong where they don't want to be? And you are forcing us to belong where we don't want to be. In Nigeria, do you see the politics this Fulani are playing? Good politics for the survival, for to thrive, to do better and do it as we are doing now. As these people have come up in that from Nasarawa Egon tribe and said, look, enough is enough. That is how to do it. Mobilize people and open their eyes. Talk to people and say, look, what is going on is not normal. If I die in this struggle, no problem. But let us have our communal benefit. Otherwise, you continue being inferior to the Fulani. Do you understand? You know, look at South governors. They say they are having meetings, stakeholders meeting, to talk about the Zamfara gold belongs to Zamfara, but Niger Delta oil belongs to Nigeria, Jigawa. Do you see the lack of unity? South-South, they say, six governors of South-South. Why can't they make it Southern governors? Do you see the inferiority complex, or the inferiorness, if that word exists, of the South in general? Whereas you have the Northern Governors Forum, which they impose even some parts of South to be North. For them to have a political voice, to be unified, to be forceful unity. Because after all, Ahmad Bello understands that as Britain can forcefully create force people together, and the South are jumping up, Southerners, Azikiwe and Co are jumping up, that, oh, we are good Nigerian, we have to make Nigeria good. It can also equally forcefully make people force them into not. Because you see that these are lower human beings. I don't know whether you understand what I mean. As you see that Britain forcefully created Nigeria by force, and you see Southerners rejoicing, we fighting for independence and maintaining it. If it hadn't been for Ahmad Bello, at independence, everybody would have gone his way. Southerners go your way, Arewa go your way. That is his mind. But you see Southerners that are these people, a creation of a foreign creation. You have created a new country, Nigeria, and you are jumping up. You want to make Nigeria better. How are you going to do it? How are you? He saw these people. Britain, Kuku tell, what do you call him? Ahmad Bello. Hand over Nigeria. He said, okay, I'll do that. That is why they can forcefully intimidate everybody, because they know that these people shouting, making one Nigeria, this and that. These are lower human beings we can also manipulate. After all, Britain can manipulate everybody and they agreed. Okay, we manipulate our own. That's it. You want to be one Nigeria, you want to be Nigeria. We will make you Nigeria, don't worry. They start creating their own. When they create a state, these people now states. People now deny their tribal identity, their ethnic nationality, in order to be a created state. That is what baffles even the Fulani. They say, these people, I never see you. These are really lower human beings. We will treat their fuck up. We will treat them. Don't worry. And that is what they are doing today. So in order to untangle what they are doing, we have to know all these things in order to change our politics. Politics of stomach, selfishness, all these things. As a Niger Delta governors, they say, see South-South governors meeting. Where do they put now Imo and Abia, that is part of South Niger Delta? You do see the foolishness of the Southern people. Why I call them very primitive Neanderthals. Primitive people at the Stone Age. You call the Fulani, they are primitive. The Fulani are not primitive. It is you that are primitive. When you, instead of being in a bunch to do something, to urinate and the thing, we have a leather. Now everybody said, okay, you make meeting South governors. Now what of Abian, the Imo State oil? Oh, you do your own and enjoy. Is that so? How do you think you can get anywhere? Why not call every South governors and say, look, this thing is too much. Let us do our own. Let us form this bunch. Remove jealousy. Remove selfishness. Remove pride. And let us do counter this northern rubbish. You know, you cannot do it because they are all slaves. And they want to be slaves. They want to continue being slaves. And the Niger Delta militants, they threatened the Niger Delta governors. Because Okowa made a statement that the 13% derivative funds, no need paying it to the communities. They pay it to the governors. Because this is only what they know, money. Pay it to the governors so that we take care of everything. Now the Niger Delta militants that are benefiting from all these things, you know them now. This is how South they use money and everything, position divided everybody, because these are very cheap human beings, cheap homo sapiens that can be bought and divided at will. That is why that's it. Until we go back to the drawing table or drawing board and know that all these characters that are making us inferior to the Fulani will continue being dominant. But they have made their water low in IPOB. That is why they are not only fighting IPOB Fulani, but they are using even Igbo people, using different Southern groups in order to fight the IPOB. That is how Fulani fight. They cannot come direct. After they will tell you that it is a It is their brother, so. It is their brother that are fighting them with, not me. I want to, for you to be powerful and dominant politically, you should be able to sacrifice your selfish interest for the communal interest. That is true. There is something I want to read here before I finish. Just a headline. Haneze Ndibu. I think they quickly even endorsed that Nnamdi Kanu incited people to scatter Yoruba property assets in Lagos. These are people that you say they are representing you. Do you see the qualities the Fulani have? The opposite is what our people have. That is why everything we are suffering. Even to this end, Yoruba, please, all your assets are vandalized by Igbos. They endorsed it. Just for the personal hatred and for their political aggrandizement, they endorse lies. But here, God is wonderful. NSAS Tribunal, November 14, 2020. Most looted businesses in Lagos are owned by Igbo. It's an army general saying this, General Ahmed Taiwo. He's testifying. Something that Ohanaeze Ndigbo and all governors have been promoting, that it is Igbos that are, God Almighty, lies from the pit of hell. Now, the military, they have testified, they have seen, they say, no, what happened? The victims are even Igbo properties that have been looted. Now, who is to share? Ohanaeze Ndigbo, of course, and the governors. Those that are lying, promoting lies, just to maintain their Nigerianism. Because that is how Fulani always put it. Are you a good Nigerian, or you are supporting secession? No, they will add there, say, no. Instead, how many people you want us to kill? We can kill 2,000, no problem, of our people. We destroy them. That is how they behave, very cheap. That is why I call them primitive Neanderthals. They are very cheap. They don't understand politics. What they do is politics of self-survival. They don't care whether their people perish. They don't care. They can do anything. But learn from the Fulani. Learn from them. How, when the heat was on internationally, everywhere about Fulani headsmen, they refused to proscribe them. They refused. He said they were defending them. Even today, they are defending Boko Haram. They are paying Boko Haram 150,000 or 160,000 naira a month. But police, they are paying 40,000, 50,000. I mean, military. Have you seen that? And these people, many of them are south and middle belt. These military boys, they will tell them, go and kill your people. They will go like zombie. But these people, they are paying their own terrorists, Boko Haram terrorists, 150,000 a month, naira. Do you see the stupidity of the black of a southerner, average southerner, very stupid, naive, stupid, selfish. Every pattern you can think of, they have it. That is why we cry every day in farms. Women are killed in your farm by Fulani headsmen. Oh, what of Osun State? Oh, in even in Anambra. Oh, in Igocha. People crying like I don't know. Little rats. That is it. I'm not insulting, but if you feel that insult, the insult the Fulanis are giving to you, killing our women and on the farm, raping them, cutting them into pieces, it's more than insult. So you have to bear it, please. You have to bear it. This Lagos general, he have indicated, he said, even the people that lost things in Lagos, they are Igbos. It is their properties that have been looted. Whereas Ohanaeze have endorsed lies. Do you see how they make us look like lower human beings, but they make themselves, not us, because we are IPOP. This is where I'm going to stop so far, so that I'll start taking calls. But before I do that, I will go on few minutes break, please, before I come back.
Thank you, Lord.
For joy coming in the morning.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
destiny
you, Lord.
Can only be delayed, or cannot be denied. Don't give up in your struggle. Jump, 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 jump. Sing it up.
Don't give up. Your miracle is on the way.
Don't give up. Your miracle is on the way.
Never lose hope. Blessings are on the way.
Don't give up. Your miracle is on the way.
Oh, your miracle.
Welcome back. This is Radio Biafra Health Service. I don't know, somebody was calling me and the music I put stops. I don't know. People should understand if until I open my lines, please, you don't call. That is, it's part of indiscipline. I'm telling you. You know? Okay, now welcome to Radio Biafra House of Service, coming to you through Radio Biafra London. I think our host, because of the system I'm using, I'm going to switch you off from the system I'm using, but we are going to organize it better so that I can pick calls. Now, our lines are open. The direct line is +1 213 328 6224. I repeat, +1 213 328 6224. Our subline is +61 405 142 547. I repeat, +61 405 142 547. You can call us now and give us your views about what we talk about, political dominant species.
No matter the calamity,
never give up.
He's the God of the last minute miracle.
He's the God of the last minute miracle.
Caller on the line, your name and where you're calling from. You're the first caller, please. Welcome to the program. Caller on the line, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Master Jonathan.
Welcome to the program.
I'm Biafra is our home. That Biafra. We as Biafra, we as Igbo. We are God and God. That is why our leader is my table. And our leader is to save the whole world. No planet Earth. We must exalt the ancient land of our ancestors, the children of Uganda. And we also pass back on this planet for apology to the power. He can't be dead.
Continue. Caller on WhatsApp, thanks for holding on. Your name and where you're calling from. Welcome to the program.
Yeah, my brother, Jonathan Schneider. My name is Mr. Chukwede. I'm calling all the way from Switzerland.
Welcome to the
program.
May
God bless you. Yeah, may God bless you and bless our leader, Mazin.
And you too.
I just want to contribute, depending on what he says about our brother in Liverline. You know, last time, Teofilos Danjuma gave them what we call the expo, that the target of Fulani is them. When the Teofilos Danjuma said they are collude, he says their target is that river line. He told our brothers there. But I don't know how the reason or how they understand. You know, there's something my father, the proverb my father always tell me, that you cannot put two hands in your mouth at once. Or in the college, you cannot eat it with you, together with the back. The problem of our brother in Liverine is, I don't know, I will not fear to call it greediness.
Don't say it's only Liverine. They target, let me tell you what the Fulani are doing. They want to outflank the mainland Igbo because they see that that is the very tough place. So when they can outflank everywhere now, you see the kind of hitting they will hit everybody. So it's not only from them, my brother. Don't blame everybody, both Igbos. Both the men Igbos from mainland, I'm telling you. It's not only them.
Okay.
Our people is it from Anambra, Imo, Ebony. Look, just what are you talking? What is that? Blame everybody. It's the same thing. I'm telling you.
Our people are so much greedy. Our people, including, but we have to do something about that. But the
look at what my word. Look at somebody that's supposed to refer him as an elder. You went to a fact-finding mission to go and ask the governor, do you do this thing? No, the governor will tell him, yes, I did it now, right? He started praising him. You see, these are people that want respect from the masses. Look at how they're behaving. Don't tell me it's only our people in River. Everybody, both in upland and you, behaving the same thing, I'm telling you.
I just want to...
Go on, my brother. It's annoying.
I just want to tell you why it's difficult for all of us to work as a brother. You know, our brothers live around feel that they are more in advantage where there is water and there is oil. That if we make peace now to us, their brothers, maybe we will start enjoy with them.
My brother, there is not. Please, let me correct this. Let me correct this notion. I don't understand what you mean if they make peace. With making peace with who? We have IPOP.
You said that each of them is making meeting now without consulting other
forces. Let me ask. How many times do southeastern governors have they ever consulted the so-called South? If they should even initiate it, what are you talking about? Have they even consulted the so-called South? They are the people that are even bringing more division. The southeast governors and southeast politicians. So don't blame everybody. Our people in the so-called southeast are even the worst. I'm telling you honestly. They are more greedy than anything because they are the people that are supposed to initiate everything.
Our leader say that any day we jump together, Fulani will run away.
That is it.
If we did not join together, Fulani will not run away there. What Fulani is called divide and our brother want to stay alone. It's not possible. Fulani will not leave that river line alone. But if we just join together, Fulani will run away. Fulani is watching us. Once we are divided, then five states cannot defeat them. But if we join together, 13 states, they will run away because they cannot defeat us together. But once it's only 6 states, they're coming, they're fighting. This is my contribution. So we have to team together.
Very much.
Fulani will run away.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. And God bless you.
Thank you very much. That is it. I don't understand. Look at Nohanese and Igbo going to. Instead of telling truth to somebody, doing something normal, you start passing, which means you are follow. Even Southeast governor, how long did they even do meeting among themselves? They don't even see eye to eye. Everybody is proud and full of himself that they cannot even. Being in that office, they feel that is their private distance. They don't understand that they are serving people, and it's people's wish that they should do. They should initiate all this thing, but they are not doing it because of their greed. Caller on direct line, your name and where you're calling from.
Good evening.
Welcome to the program.
All delivered.
My name is Pirimentika from Moving Gwaba. I'm calling from Republic Kotonu Kesavile. As a American Trover, keep you, all of you, and Hamariki, one of Biafra land. It's not easy. American Trover, keep all of you for us. Now, this is what I want to add this night. You see, our people always think that the Fulanese doesn't have any, don't know anything. That because they went to school and they grab English language, which is a adopted language from a white man, and claim that because they can speak English better than the Fulanese, that the Fulanese don't know anything. And then the Fulanese is even more master than them. Rather than the land, Fulani was planning to have Nigeria as their own land, which became 100%. Nevertheless, they really said, they are working towards that land by their grandfather. That's what I mean. Fighting communal survival, fighting communal race. But our people, what are we doing? Public. May you ask me, where do you from? You say I'm a Yoruba, but I'm not from Nigeria. I'm Yoruba in Benin. But if it's an Igbo man, as long as a Frenchman have now made that boundary and call you from today,
he's even a Frenchman.
He's not himself.
He said, no,
I'm not Igbo, I'm a Benin. I'm a Benin, come from heaven. But I meet a Yoruba, my friends in here. When I see Yoruba with them, they respond with the Yoruba language. Exactly. Even if they speak their dialect, I always understand their own dialect, but not everything, because I understand Yoruba language. That was I understand their dialect. The dialect they see here, that dialect is an Anago. If you don't understand Yoruba language very well, you cannot understand it. But if I ask them, they will never tell me that they are Igbo. No. They say I'm a Yoruba, but I'm not a Igbo, but I'm not from Nigeria. I'm Yoruba. But Igbo man, because the white man have put in that name, Bene, and made a hand, he denied himself. He said, we start speaking English with you. That is when we say, people, they will come to your shop to buy market. They know that you are Igbo man, these are Igbo people living here. They will start speaking nonsense in this language, trying to deny themselves who they are, trying to deny their identity. Then that your language and your name is there, and your name of your community and your name of your father or your grandfather signify where you came from. You see, then speaking English, claim that maybe pretend as if they are Britain, they are from white people, they are no longer Igbo. That is why I don't know the kind of mentality of people have. They always think that the Fulani is not anything. Fulani is a master planner. They have the knowledge of political survival as a race. In terms of fighting for their people, for their own race, they don't go for education, they go for their communal survival to achieve one goal for their own people. Look at a man who named it Wike, because Gowan now come and give you a river state. Now you are now a river man, you are now a white man, you are no longer an Igbo man. Rivers come from heaven, you are now a white man. This is how people are selfish human beings.
How can this type of people be on top politically? It's impossible. It's impossible.
Why is Fulani down here? Also, see Fulani in Nigeria and his brother. Fulani in Mali. Say he is a Fulani by ethnic group. It doesn't matter the border name they share. He knows himself as a Fulani man. Now, a Yoruba man in Kogi now, Nkwara State, can you ask a Yoruba man now in Kogi State now, which ethnic are you? He can never say he's a Fulani. He say, I'm a Yoruba man. That's why the Yoruba in Nkwara, which Fulani are opposed Emia to their land, they conquer them from them. One, if you ask them, which ethnic group are you? I'm a Yoruba. He can never say that he's a Fulani man because Fulani is ruling them. No. Do you see how people have mental problems? Those who think that they can speak good English, is a lie. Knowledge, wisdom is bigger than that English you are speaking. Think that because you speak English, that makes you somebody who have knowledge. Is a lie. You know nothing.
Of course. You know nothing. Thank you very much, my brother.
How many people can speak good English like you? How many people can speak good English like those of them who claim they are intellectuals in Igbo land? But look at what these things are doing. Mother, I don't want to hands up from here and report to people because I'm managing to make from a farm.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, my brother.
This is it. Caller on WhatsApp, your name and where you're calling from. Caller on WhatsApp. Thank you for having patience. Caller on WhatsApp.
Thank you, Master Jonathan.
Yes, welcome to the program.
Yes, I can hear you, my brother. Good evening from here. This is Master Rafu Dodle Ndikom. I came from Umuaka in Olo province, Biafra land. But I served the indigenous people of Biafra here in Russia as the national coordinator. Biafrans and the friends of Biafrans around the globe, greeting from Moscow, Russia Federation capital. Indeed, she said once again to have access to our radio, even interaction. Actually, the area I want to talk tonight is concerning the level of the saboteur in a high level, at least we have in Biafra land, especially among Igbo politicians. It is really alarming. Because from every indication I have shown that these people have sold us completely. The only thing that is holding Fulani Janjaweed to accomplish their will is the fear of Nnamdi Kanu and the IPOB. That's the only thing that is holding them from completely taking over our land. For coming to our politicians, Igbo politicians, they already sold our land completely. And now it's the Fulanis that are deciding who will be even local chairman. Even Fulanis that the people that decide who will be the chairman of motor park in our village, in our villages. Fulanis are the people now deciding who will be market manager or president. Every political post in Igbo land, any person that you see they are Fulani appointee. So that is the level and the mess that we have seen ourselves. And why? What I want to touch tonight is the reason that the expansion and the increase of these saboteurs. The reason for the increase of saboteurs in Igbo land is because after the Biafra-Nigeria war of aggression, the genocidal war that orchestrated by British and their cohorts in 1966 to 1970 to exterminate Biafran people. After the war, our great hero, Jim Odumegwu Ojukwu, the only one mistake he made after the war, that is what we are suffering today. The mistake he made after the war is that he left and he forgave all the people that sabotage the Biafran genocide war. All the people that betrayed him, he forgave them, he overlooked them, he allowed them. All the people that now we always mention our people in Riverland, they call themselves Niger Delta and whatnot, River State and artificial River State that was created by Gowon. All those people. Ojukwu forgive them. Ojukwu allow them to enjoy the abandoned property of their own of their own people. All the people that play sabo during the war, Ojukwu left them alive. That is the reason why, when these people, the other people that joined politicians after the war, they saw how these people that are served during the war and Nigeria. How they're flourishing, how they're expanding. Then they see it as a lucrative business. They see sabotage in Biafra as a lucrative business. That's why many people are trooping in. That's why every day we are getting there, that the Fulanis are getting new babies of saboteurs that they will use to kill us. Because you cannot see the reason why that this useless idiot that calls himself a freedom fighter, Wadrike, can open his mouth to encourage other governors to emulate genocide to kill our people. Why? The thing has reached to that level that this man can have the boldness to open his mouth to tell other governors to kill Biafrans like Asimuke did. So, what am I saying? That this for us to make sure that this thing that this cancer But this virus, we don't, will not transfer to our children and our future grandchildren. That is future grandchildren. It's for us, this generation of IPO, to make sure that even after this rain that's going to fall, when it ends, it will not end there. It will continue until in Biafra land there will be no single that is remnant of every saboteur. I'm not talking of dealing with their fathers or their this. No, to make sure that their generation is completely uprooted from Biafra land. That is the solution. Because if we leave any of them, they will still contaminate other people. And in Biafra land, even if you get Biafra, within 5 years or 10 years, Biafra will be like Nigeria. Biafra will be like Nigeria. But if after we get Biafra, even if after our leaders say they are forgiving them, we youth say that these people they will not live, the generation will not live, and they will not live. We make sure that we deal with them and we complete it, clear them out of our way, so that we can be able to have a better society. So that's my contribution tonight. And I want to pray that Mazu, our leader Nandi, can help us, is that Chukwuka will bless him and keep him and guide him for us, because we need him now more than any other time. And all the members of IPOB worldwide, let us be strong and know that we are almost at the end of the battle.
Thank you.
And victory is ours. I'm signing off here, most gracious. Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Caller Pastor Jack, are you there? Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Mark Jonathan. Good evening from here.
Welcome to the program.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, fellow Biafrans and lovers of freedom all around the world. My name is Pastor Jack. I just want to add my voice this night. First of all, it is quite understandable that Fulani people have been able to outsmart those who have all the quantums or levels of degrees that cannot be quantified in the so-called South. Our Dudua brothers have woken up. But unlike our own people that have decided to be scapegoat and scavengers to the Fulani people, they help this common enemy to defraud, to deceive, to kill and maim our people. And through them, these people have been able to get a strong foot in our lands. I'm talking about all the present serving governors, both in the Southeast and in the South, what they call South South. At the same time, most important was Ohanaeze, because Ohanaeze is a very good tool that was formulated by Fulani in 1970. First of all, let's talk about.
So I can touch you out.
Now, the Fulani administrator in Imo State, he arrested one of our brothers, Haji Ebe, because they removed or they released the former teacher who ran to join the administrator to remove the Hedua. And immediately they removed the Hedua and jumped to the side of the Fulani administrator in the Imo State. But now, unknown to him, that same man that jumped on his own side, they are going to remove him. Now, also Dimba have gone to detain our person in a police custody. But meanwhile, I just want to send him a message tonight on how the people have. Peace. We'll give you 1 week. Water line. We'll give you 1 week. You see, pipeline. We will open it for you. We are going to open it. I hope when we talk for Haji, I hope you hope nobody need to tell you about Haji, because Emma Kelly did she give before now. Nobody need to tell you what we can do. Walter Smith, we will bring Walter Smith down. If that our brother is not being released, because he don't have the constitutional right to return a House of Assembly member, because the impeached speaker, who are you? Because Fulani gender people appointed you. to do their bidding, and they are jumping up and down. We must, all of us together, collectively, in Imo must deal with you in order for you to learn a lesson. Because you are not a governor. We never elected you. Now, having said that, go back to Imo, where the stupid small Hitler is claiming Igwacha is not Igbo land. And you know, after inviting the army to kill our people, MBA decided they are going to make investigation on the extrajudicial killing. That Hitler, he went on National Daily to up MBA. That they should submit whatsoever they have to the panel of inquiry set in Igwacha. Have you seen where somebody have a case at the same time be a judge in this case? The Lord Mazin has it. Nemo Judas in Kasasaw. You cannot be a judge over your own case. So he started starting MBA because you know what? He knows that there's no way after the investigation. Was running, he's running Heta Skater to see if he can talk his way out of that. To set up the panel and do the investigation or not. For solid pay for the atrocities he committed. For over 2,000 persons, you kill in Obiwo. But the one he threw inside for a pit in the guise of the answers. Protest, you kill over 2,000 of our people, you never go free. Now, these people or these individuals have decided to start serve this Fulani people because they are not wanting to be trusted, they have never been reliable. In fact, as I'm talking to you, the level of people Michi has killed, and Michi has never killed that number of people. We It's only what we can did in Igwacha, but we pay you back with your coin. It's no longer a question of that is just the truth. And for those of people you are deceiving, telling them you are not an Igbo man, you can deceive yourself from today to tomorrow. Igwacha is Igbo land. You can never. Another person hand over to for this very time. I think for the Sarai constitution, wake up and rise up at this very important time. Feed their strength, feed their family.
Give your children a job, and they don't bother. They don't care about you. That is the reason why all must rise to join IPOB, to stop them at all costs. But if you don't stop them, Thank you very much.
Thank you. Caller on WhatsApp, thank you for putting on your name and where you're calling from. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, Mazi Jonathan.
Today. Welcome to the
my
program.
My name is Kinsilos. Thank you, my brother. I thank my leader. Thank you for your program. And Jacob, you know, why I try to say something about this, your program now you're talking about. I'm telling you, the British people that put us together, there will be a time the youth generation of today of the southern eastern region will react. We are handing over Portuguese and the Spanish hand us over to the British. Pure. The British is an Anglican. We have been practicing a Roman Catholic for them. This is, they know that this youth of today, we will react in a brutal way, very deadly, honestly speaking, very deadly. And they are expecting us to do more. And that more, they are expecting us to do. You see, all the whole southern eastern region politicians go after them. We need to go after these people. Anyhow, crucify them, let vulture start swallowing their skin. These people, we will never in life in this struggle to expect these people to go and represent us in National Assembly or House of Rep. As a minority, they will threaten them, they will do them anything for them, even to give them pocket money to shut up. So in this struggle, we never expect these people to fight for us, and they will never in life be somebody to represent us. If they want to do anything, being them a politician in Biafra land, they go to Ezai. Our leader is still there. He helped them and know how to do what, organize our youth. Because this battle, no retreat, no surrender. The hard way is the only way. And we must continue. As we enlighten these people living at home, we'll be supporting them. Aid them with everything, military equipment, and anything we can do. That is the only solution, because of what? The Fulani people that are coming, the people that hand us over to British, before them, they know that these people have been penetrating several times, and they are dying. Mazi Jonathan, we need to do something.
Thank you very much.
God bless you.
And you too.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra. We must continue. The issue is the issue on this is, as I said before, the political dominance, it comes with many things. It comes with sacrifices, which the Fulanis, they have been doing. Unity, selflessness, all these are things that go with political dominance. Because when you arrange yourself in all these things, now the end result is you become politically, you become politically dominant. Let me pick this call. Caller on WhatsApp, your name and where you're calling from. Welcome to the program.
Jonathan, get yourself from here.
Welcome to the program.
My name is Mazi Emeka. I'm calling from Indianapolis, USA. Mazi, I thank you for your good work you are doing for people. I thank you for your time. Mazi, am I coming out here?
You are.
So my contribution today is all this efulefu calling themselves Igbo governors or Igbo senators. All these people supposed to gather one place and burn them alive, because these people are idiots. Ewuna ma they are goats. Goats are even smarter than them. Look at the way you analyze Fulani from Adam from 1960 and Ezekiel, a so-called professor in the United Kingdom, fighting for the whole Africa to get the Ezekiel of Africa. Whereas Fulani that we say they don't go to school, they are gathering their skills. Look at it. That's why today Fulani will come as boldly in the TV and say, oh, in the Niger Delta, so-called Niger Delta, belong to them. They ask the man why. Because they are landmass. These are people that came home, they are not English people. And you see people from Southern, who they said they go home. They post-cap IPOP. These people, are they human beings? Are you post-caping with our mothers that have given product this money? A mother that have grandchildren, have high class science education in abroad. Some of them are doctors. Some of them have different professional skills. And if you are today saying they are proscribed to be a terrorist, these people, are they not, are they human beings? Go around, they sit openly. They will be giving them 50,000 a month. Okay? And the whole Nigeria said they proscribed for the X-Men. The fourth most deadly terrorist in the world. Recognized by the United Nations. And the Fulani came and said, no, that we will never proscribe them. And this is your the proscribing people that have American passport, say they are terrorists. Don't you see, these people call their state governor. These people need to burn our lives because they're not there for us. Because they know that our people, they're buying and selling. They know that they're buying, they don't even care about properties. That's why they can be talking every jackals in their mouth. You see why I never believe, I never trust anybody that come out and support the IPOP. For anybody to become popular, will support IPOB. Look at the way Amayanabo Dokubo start the beginning time. Look at the way we can start the beginning time. Look at what this about to do on Facebook start the beginning time. This is the why. The only person I support, the only person I support and listen to anytime is Mars and Adekano. Any one of us that can't have the fake people. I never trust the one day. Look at now. All of them now. Nobody can say that the Boko Haram they are giving 150,000, they are terrorists. No. Even minimum wage, they're even getting 30,000 minimum wage. But the better Boko Haram are getting. And if those people, Dubai, in Arab world, come out and say they are arrested, they will change their life imprisonment. And yet, Nigeria, and the so called certain educated professor, doctor degree, journalist, nobody say nothing. No. Rather, they all challenge the agenda, they all frustration to American election. This is the same thing people do in 2015. This is the same thing people come out supporting Buhari against Kumata. Economic in Africa, Nigeria is number one. In the world, number 10. This one I'm fighting NSAS. I don't support evil. The same is one I'm supporting NSAS now. The campaign, the way these people are campaigning now to Joe Biden, this is the same way these people are campaigning for this 2015. People don't have shame, because me, there's something I will do. If I fail it now, instead of for me to go back and lick my shit again, I will just keep silent. But these people don't have no shit. Come out and say, answer, revolutionary. Don't you know Buhari? I know that man is older than me. Obviously, you're showing car and all these churches in Nigeria, all these are devil church. They are older than me. They know how Buhari treated people. How do you think Buhari will change this one? This is the same way people now are fighting, say Joe Biden number one, Joe Biden number one. But they fall to get, don't forget that this Joe Biden, they don't have to bring this guy out. They don't have to bring Nigeria in this mess. But because of Trump, Obando, Nigeria restriction, visa. Because these people don't have sense, they recruit Boko Haram to the society. Don't you know that these people, they come to society, they can get visas, normal people, and travel abroad, and come and burn them, the way they burn 9/11. I want a president not to protect his own land because of they don't give your brother visa. That's why I want to support your party. This is the same way people support this Buhari. You know why? This Buhari regime didn't shake any IPOB because we know we prepare. Then the nation will be like this. Like what we are telling people now. This is America
come and sit down. Where Jehovah enter? When I go yella, everybody will be hear it because we don't support it. We have the mind to hear it. Okay, we can come out now. I say it's not evil. Did I need the professor to teach me that this fool I need? They have been laughing to this man. The same thing that do Sarah Wewa, we can hear older than me 100 times. The same thing that do Sarah Wewa, the same thing that will do to you because you don't have sense. You answer some, you will see Nigeria answer your Korea. If I, but what are you answering? Eh? Look at India. Today, India celebrate their Diwali festival. Everywhere in America, yeah, they make it known to everybody in their culture. Are you educated that India in America? Are you in the big post that India in America? No, because you people are inferior complex. Because this is culture in evil people too much. Eh? You say evil person speaking evil. You say I'm not musician. Who are you? Spanish? Are you stronger than? Are you educated than Spanish people? Than Mexican people? But they're part of their culture. But you are not part of culture because you are, that's why you have your children. You begin to your children, Stella, Linda. Because you don't trust, you don't know your heritage. You know your heritage. You be part of them, part of your land. That's why this day, we call us governors. We come out to shamelessly say, those people that kill for war. Look for war. These people are killing Fulani S-men. Killing our mother. The same day, Bumaye came out 2 years ago, last year. Then they kill our mother. Rape our mother in the farm. The same you come, who is fighting war now? War is in your doorstep. The same you that is, yes, federal government to look into NSA's matter. Now you come again, change the land. Kete Baya Unu, Unu Atatap one day. You must have been to the rulings in Ghana. But even we don't know that George J.C. Rollins case is coming to you one by one. Because we can repair escape this one. Because this one is not, this one will be 1960.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Caller on direct line, thank you for holding on. Can you hear me, Mazi?
Yes, Mazi, I can hear you loud and clear. Mazi, good evening from here.
Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Mazi. Yes. My name is Mazi, my man, Ugonye Jaka. I am the national PRO of IPOB here in United States. I reside here in Washington, D.C. I am from Amiibo, Amiibo in Olo. Amiibo is the home of the tiger, and Amiibo is the home of Njajun. Mother, thank you so much for your analysis, and I thank God Almighty for bringing back our brother from Nasarawa. Mother, what I am saying today is that I am extremely very hopeful. Seeing the way things are going and the rate at which the IPOB is getting ground. Here in United States, here in the capital of United States, that is Washington, D.C., I happened to meet one of those guys, the Reverend, who helped to fight for the apartheid in South Africa. And then that Reverend, at the same time, fought for the Southern Sudan. The Reverend was telling me that he had never seen the freedom fighter that is as fast and as diverse as IPOB. He said that what the South African fought for so long and then the Southern Sudan fought for so long, the IPOB have been able to gain ground so fast that you can't even imagine. He said that I should urge the youth of Biafra, the youth in that contraction, for them to stand their ground and continue. Because no matter whoever that is the president of the United States of America, America stands for justice and America stands for freedom, that we are going to get our freedom. This is what the guy told me. So I am telling you again and I'm assuring you, because we are in the digital era. Because you know what happened in Nigeria? The politics of Nigeria is the politics of gangsters. They are just like the animal that are in the cage. They don't know what is going on around the world. So they can do anything with impunity. But they don't know that we have gone so far. Mazi, the world is a global village. Everything you do, definitely it is written, it is in the archive. And any statement you make is going to be used against you at any time because everything is documented. It is out there. The issue there is that Wike is a very stupid, hopeless man. He don't know that he have dug a grave for himself, I am telling you. Both internationally and internally, he did that. I want the people that call themselves Nigeria to know what Nigeria is. Remember, the British people started with Royal Niger Company. Royal Niger Company is a company of Britain that is in that area you call Nigeria. And now, when British were leaving, then they changed the name to Nigeria. It is the same company of Britain that was run as a private company of Britain, that they now changed the name to Nigeria instead of Royal Niger Company. It is still that same company that they are running up to today. But the unfortunate thing is that the Fulani have miscalculated. They have miscalculated because, they minimize the IPOB. They don't know the extent that we have gone. Now, I thank God that Nnamdi Kanu is not only the leader of IPOB, but the leader of the youth in that contraction called Nigeria. He have already taken the mantle, and that mantle is on him. Nnamdi Kanu is the leader of the youth of Nigeria. The youth that their destiny has been stolen from them, Nnamdi Kanu is the speaker. I thank God that we have this forum. We have this Radio Biafra, which is available to anybody that is marginalized in that contraction. This is your mouthpiece. This is where you can say what you feel like without anybody editing it or anybody, using propaganda on it. You say it the way it is. So I am urging you, if you are a youth that you have found yourself in this contraction, stand up, because you don't have any future. Follow IPOB, follow Nnamdi Kanu. We are fighting for everybody. In as much as we are fighting for Biafra, and Biafra we must get. We are helping Oduduwa itself. We are fighting for Oduduwa. And we are fighting for Middle Belt. For them just to have their freedom. You cannot come, the person that is ruling you are the Fulanis of West Africa. Fulanis that have their nation, they say the nation of Fulani. And this nation of Fulani can find it in every aspect of the West Africa. Now they have hijacked the military in Nigeria. They have hijacked the armed forces. They are using their militia. They are using the Fulani, herdsmen as their foot soldiers and coming and intimidating. So I'm telling the people that find themselves in Biafra land, all the saboteurs that think that they have gotten away with everything, we are documenting all your thing. All your name have been documented. And there is no way that you can go free. As for Biafra, Biafra is coming. And there is no two ways about it. So the guy that called from Zamfara, in the middle belt,
Nasarawa.
Calling, inform Nasarawa, my brother, go ahead and start. We stand by you at any time. Go ahead and tell your brothers, tell everybody, be calling Radio Biafra, calling. This is a platform for you. This platform was established for the youth, all of you. You from Nasarawa, you from Zamfara, you from Southern Kaduna, you from the middle belt, you from Oduduwa, you are your Biafra. Well, do you know that in Biafra land, all these our saboteurs think that the world rotate around them. They don't know that we have gone far. they don't know that we are not in the same state that they are. Okay? So we are here, you are dealing with the people that are civilized, you are dealing with professionals, you are dealing with the doctors, you are dealing with the teachers, you are dealing with the nurses, you are dealing with the clergy, all the PhD holders that are in abroad. That is the people that you are dealing with. Believe me, by the time we finish with you, definitely you will know that we mean business. It's not business as usual. So, Mazi, continue doing a good job. We are watching, and the whole world is listening. I am telling you, here in Washington, this is the capital of the United States. All their eye and their ear are open. They are seeing what is happening. So for the fact that they are not reacting, that doesn't mean that something is not going on the ground. That is what I am telling all the Biafrans. If we're all of them that think that, No. We are here in the digital era, and everything is documented, and we are doing the ground job that we are doing. Nigeria, you see today, you will not see it anymore. Thank God for Maazi Nnamdi Kanu. Maazi, thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you very much, Maazi. We must continue. I think we are winding down on this program. I don't know, before I continue to closing the program or making the final remarks, please Let me come back again to Maazi Jacob. Are you there? Maazi Jacob, can you hear me? Maazi Jacob, are you there? I don't know. It seems you're not. Okay. I want you to proceed to making your closing remark, because I'm trying to also bring Malam Yusuf, that is Apostle Yusuf. I don't know whether he's there or not. But go on, please.
I want him to I want him to be around, because you know when you can still connect him. Let him be around.
He's not around, so I'm calling him. He's ringing, but he's not around yet. Anyway, you can go on, because tomorrow is another day. You see, there's something I want you to understand. You see the importance of consistency. You know, when you are doing something, you think that people doesn't remark. You know, you continue doing the thing. Don't mind. When you start paying dividends, you will be surprised. So that is the importance of consistency in anything, as far as you understand that you are doing the right thing. That is the most important thing. As far as you know that you are doing the right thing, that is the most important thing. If you are satisfied in you that you are doing the right thing, come on. It doesn't matter who castigates. It doesn't matter. Go on doing what you are doing, and it will pay dividends, because people, like-minded people, will come in. So, Maazi Jacob, are you there? Okay, over to you. No, it's not connected. It's not connected. I called him. It's ringing bell. Go on. Make your closing remark. Don't worry. Tomorrow is another day.
Thank you. I agree with everybody, and I feel happy that he is one of my brother, to come for the program. And before I do my closing remark, one of my eyewitness today, I don't know how this country, the country, they rule, like, say, person.
It takes a year to understand me.
So, now I beg you, now
your brother is back online, so. Yusuf, are you here? Apostle Yusuf. Okay. Are you there? Apostle Yusuf, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So I just want you to, are you there, Mazi Jacob? Okay, please just wait 5 minutes.
Why?
Closing remarks.
Why?
Okay. Mazi Yusuf.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Yusuf or Madam Yusuf or Apostle Yusuf is the same thing.
Ah, no, don't call me Yusuf. Can you call him Vladu? Vladu.
Vladu, okay.
Vladu.
It's okay.
Yes.
It's okay. Yeah, so it's good having you on this program. And let me tell you one thing, as I told you before privately, because we are on air. This platform is for everybody. As far as you are looking for freedom, as far as you are here for the liberation of the people, because Nigerians are under bondage. I'm telling you honestly, it doesn't matter which tribe you are. Everybody is under bondage. The only people that are gaining are the politicians. That is the basis. So we are, you know, many people used to misunderstand us or misinterpret or lie against us that, oh, this is for Igbo only, this is for Biafra. No. We want, you know, when Nigeria is a place, it's a contraption whereby Britain forced people. They didn't ask for people's
opinion
before amalgamating people together.
Mm.
That is why, you know, it is ignorance in the part of people, mostly southerners and even middle belters, shouting one Nigeria, one Nigeria, one Nigeria. The Fulani say that Nigeria belongs to them, is their property. That is the difference. So people that are shouting one Nigeria, you are doing Nigeria, building Nigeria for the Fulani. That is the thing. So the only, we have seen east, west, we have calculated 360 degrees and seen that Nigeria is irredeemable. There is no way you can redeem Nigeria because it has a faulty foundation. So the only solution for a structure that has a faulty foundation is to pull it down and rebuild it. Now, once it's down, people can discuss if they want to come back to be called another name. Because Nigeria, first of all, is an insult. It's an ethnic, a racial slur.
Niger area. So that is the thing. So it is now meant for you now to enlighten more, help your brother Jacob, because these two is better than one. And others, I know others are listening. You enlighten people on what you, I mean, your own people. Because we want, you know, a successful Biafra and a successful middle belt as nations, different nations, they will be good neighbors. That is why in Western Europe, people are not suffering. Somebody from France, he doesn't, to Germany, they, you know, they interact. You know, somebody will leave Paris, France, and go to work in England, and in the night he will go back. It's international because every transport infrastructure, very easy. So we can work better if we become our nations. Like all these marginalizations you are talking about. Imagine you have your or separate nation, which you agree as a people. No person will marginalize you because it becomes your own thing direct. You cannot marginalize yourself. So that is what we are preaching. So I want you now, please, you can make your closing remark. 5 minutes, yes.
All right. Manzi, Jonathan, I want to appreciate you. I have been following up people call from different parts of the country. Actually, I follow you neatly. All that you have explained, I have got them very well. And I want to appreciate you for that wonderful and beautiful presentation. Actually, I want to also appreciate all those who have called to say one thing or the other. Actually, we will educate our people even right now. I have invited about 30 people today. They downloaded Radio Biafra and they are also following up. Right now that I am talking, they are listening to me. They told me that they have been playing my music. I said, glory be to God, dude. That means my music has been circulated.
You are the person that played the music, right?
Yeah, it's my song.
Okay, good.
It was the one that gave Jacob. I'm an
artist. Yes, go on.
They said hello. So we want to appreciate you for giving us audience, giving us an opportunity. We shall be the youth to say Igbo people are very devious. Igbo people, they can, you know, when they get Biafra that they're going to enslave everybody. There was this wrong impression. So when you are telling somebody to join Radio Biafra to say God forbid, why should they be? Are they Igbos? I say, it's not about Igbo, it's about liberation and emancipation. You see, you need to give me like more time. I'm also a leader of the land. So when I begin to speak, I believe very soon you are going to get more number of people that will download IPO Community Radio. And by God's grace, time to time, we shall continue to educate our people. I want to appreciate you for this privilege. I want to thank you for this opportunity. I also appreciate Kanu for this wonderful and inspirational vision. So we believe that when my brother was saying 2023, I say even if they will share this country in 2021, I'm ready. I will say, let the Biafra go, we maybe they will go and wait. Yoruba should go. I think it should be better. Why should they begin to accumulate to suffering us for nothing sake? So I am abide about that there. And you know, in my state now, majority of my people who finish from school, no work for them. And let them share it now so that we get opportunity to see we can fix ourselves. Why should one region dominate everybody? It's an error. So that is my little contribution. Thank you for giving the opportunity. And may the Lord help us in Jesus' name, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And you too. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Tomorrow is another day. And we urge every one of listeners hearing our voice today. This is Radio Biafra House of Service coming to you through Radio Biafra London. My name remains Mazi Jonathan Chinedu, and with me is Mazi Jacob Embassy and our brother Apostle John Apostle Yusuf, sorry, that is Joseph. You know, Yusuf is the same thing as Joseph. It's just Yusuf is Arabic or Hebrew. I don't know. Yusuf is Arabic and a kind of Hebrew in language. But it's also Joseph.
Yes.
I cannot get the other name, but I will try to cram it. And tomorrow we'll join again here in order to say it. One thing is sure, here, we don't pity people. I'm telling you. We surgically, we are trying to surgically remove idiocy, ignorance, and foolishness.
Yes.
Because that is the problem that we are having. Ignorance. People are ignorant. They are not informed. And you cannot know the truth without hearing it. Because you know the amount of information or the type of information that you gather, that you swallow, it is who you are. In Nigeria, the mainstream media, they never tell you the truth. Look at Chinese television, TVC News, AIT, all these jargons. These are people, these are stations that benefit. How are they sponsored? They benefit from the misery of the people, the rotten system, because they are owned by the politicians or sponsored by the politicians. The same people people are fighting against. So how do you think that they can give you good things? They will polish something and bring to you as what they want you to hear is what they are going to give to you. That is why, you know, today the Nigerian government is trying hard in order to regulate social media so that you go back to that stupor, that blindness. But it cannot happen, I'm telling you, because we are in 21st century. Here on Radio Biafra, London, we say it as it is without mincing words. Even it doesn't matter, we try to surgery. You know, when you are doing surgery, when you have, for example, appendicitis, they are doing surgery, it will pain you. They open your stomach, you know, they don't massage it, they open it. Blood will gush out, but they are saving you because they are removing something that will kill you if you leave it inside. The same thing we are doing here, that foolishness, that ignorance, and that naivety that is killing you is what we are removing from your brain, because the problem of a black man is in the brain. Everybody is shouting against Fulani headsmen, Fulani headsmen, Fulani, Fulani, Fulani. A little minority, less than 7 million people, tormenting the lives of 193 million people plus. Now you ask, why? How is it so? That is why I try to analyze today what makes them dominant as they are politically over others. No matter that Southerners and Middle Belters, they go to Western Egypt, they go to school more than. But they are more stupid and foolish. Look at how they are paying Boko Haram, so-called Boko Haram repentant soldiers, repentant terrorists, 150,000, 160,000 naira every month. But the military, the soldiers that are fighting these terrorists, they are paying them 50,000 naira, 40,000 naira. And these soldiers, they don't even think. How? And they will send them down to go and kill their brothers, even Southerners. Middle Belters in the military, they will send them, go to Anambra, go to Benue, kill your people, and they will do it happily. They are obeying others. Can't you see that these people are unreasonable? Although, thank God that they are opening eyes, because many military Southerners and Middle Belters, they are overwhelmingly coming out, running away from the Nigerian military. And that is a good thing to do, I'm telling you. Because we should not continue in this ignorance. The Fulani, they don't have any pity, no sentiment. They are marching to conquer and subjugate everybody. Now they are using your political class against you. Like in Biafra land, you see the politicians they impose on every one of us, trying to deliver the people in a place to the Fulani. But we cannot accept it. Never. Not today, not tomorrow. because we cannot continue this ignorance from right from beginning, the time of our political, predecessors, like Azikiwe. We continue calling his name, because had it been he is knowledgeable, as he should be, as a learned person, he should have understood the game, because Ahmadu Bello understood the game, and he told it truth. He told the British, you know, that this thing you are creating, it cannot work. We are mixable, cannot work. And when the British, they saw him and cornered him, say, look, we know you are a Kaiman. Your eyes are open. But leave these people that want to make Nigeria great. They go to school. Is it not from a way that train them? Don't worry. Come. We hand Nigeria over to you. Do it as you want. As far as we are looting. And that is what is happening till date. For how long are we going to continue like this? For how long? This unity among us? For how long? It's better middle birds, they go their way. Biafra their way. Otutuwa their way. If tomorrow now we want to come in to answer one name to be in one country, it is now for us to determine and discuss the terms for it. That we favor us, we negotiate. That is how normal human beings do. Not defending a country that foreigners created for themselves. And you are calling yourself a normal human being. You are not. That is why we are here. Anyway, we have to draw the curtain. This is where I'm going to draw the curtain here. And as I've been telling you, as you know, my name remains Mazi Jonathan Chinedu from Olu province of Biafra land. Tomorrow is another day, and we must continue in our preaching. We must continue. You know, there is something somebody said in Mazi Ike Peter's program. He said, or it's Mike Peter that said it. He said, our leader is now on the ground. And people now want him to talk. When he's talking, people are saying, he's talking, now we want you, why not come up and do something your own as you castigate Mazi Nnamdi Kanu? If what you are doing, you know, you outdo Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, people will follow you. We follow you, no problem. But what our people knows is how to castigate. What is the solution? They don't know. Just to fight, to make sure they scatter everything. And that is a very primitive character. Very, very primitive. I'm telling you. That is why we are suffering. That is why people that suppose not, that cannot even, should not be able to remove our shoelaces are ruling over us. Anytime any person come up, you see people fighting. Our people fighting our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, fighting IPOB. For what? They don't even know. Oh, you are bringing problem to Igbo people. Were you enjoying before? Look at ordinary roads, road blocks from Lagos to east. From Lagos to where it's more than 200 road blocks. It's true. It's more than. And people will be shocked. You know, this is economic strangulation. You know, people will say, oh, no, things are, is that how, I used to see people, right? Is that how things are going to be in Biafra? Transportation is more costly. Everything is more costly in Southeast. I say, look at. That is, you don't know that we are under economic strangulation. All these roadblocks, do you think that they are there for just for for your betterment? They collect money from transporters. As they are collecting money, anything, the goods these people are carrying, each 500 naira they collect, they will add it to the goods. Who is paying? Is you and I, the people, the masses, that they are paying. So something you get 1,000 naira in Lagos, in Southeast it can be 3,000 or 2,005. That's it. Because the people that are transporting they have to put their gain, they have to make gain, otherwise they will lose or they will stop the business. They are passing everywhere, they are passing the roads and they pay. Police make them pay. And do you know what? Many politicians in Biafra land, they are gaining. You know what they are doing is abateke. These police people, at the end of the week or month, they have their share. That is why when you talk from now till tomorrow, the police, they are still there. Do you understand? That is the evil in our land. And our people should go back to farming also. Farming. This looking for money. Money is ordinary paper. Do you understand that? Money is ordinary paper. If you have the best car and you didn't eat for 2 days, and there is no food, you have money full your pocket, you don't see nothing to buy. That your car you bought 20 million naira. You can even sell it for one bag of rice. Or for one tube of yam. Just to feed your belly for that. Because it becomes useless. That money in your pocket becomes useless. Pure useless. Do you understand? Let us stop this thing of allowing food to come from outside. Let us be farming. He who feeds you controls you. That is the word of Thomas Sankara. You understand? Let us, even any space we have, Obubo, in our farm, we farm, we do something so that we shall not totally depend on outsiders for food. Because if they block it, you go hungry. That your money you are looking for, it cannot save you. That car you have, it cannot save you. That your mansion, you cannot eat it. Because the most important thing in life is to feed. That is the most important thing as a living thing, to feed. If you don't feed, you die. Every other thing around you becomes useless. Anything you gather, even if you have gold or silver, it becomes useless to you. What you have, what you'll be looking for is what sustains you, what you put inside your mouth and sustains you. That is it. You understand that? That is why, like my father told me, he said, during the Biafra, the last war, Biafra-Nigeria war, people that suffer most are big men. People that live inside cities, they are the most victims of hunger. Because villagers, they know how to manipulate and do something. But these people, you know, these city dwellers, they don't even know nothing. Most people, even born in the cities, they don't know nothing. That's it. So this is where I'm going to draw the curtain, please. From me and from our comrades with me, this is good evening.